After a second-place finish in the Big West, the Rainbow Wahine volleyball team was granted new life, awarded a second consecutive at-large bid to the NCAA tournament. On the other side of the net, 25th-ranked Baylor also finished second in the Big 12 and looks to make a statement in its third straight championship tournament appearance. Coming up, it's tourney time. First round action between the Baylor Bears and the Hawaii Rainbow Wahine. And we welcome you inside the Matthew Knight Arena on the campus of the University of Oregon in Eugene, Oregon. A big aloha to you here courtside, Kanoa Leahy next to Chris McLaughlin. And Chris, there were a lot of people who were skeptical about the fact that Hawaii would even have a chance to play in this national postseason. Well, here they are.
Well, I was skeptical too until the last weekend. The right teams won and the right teams lost for Hawaii to go all the way to number 46 in the RPI off the and into the tournament. How exciting is that?
The planets essentially aligned for this team. And so here they are, given that second chance opportunity. You kind of see it in the vibe. The mentality of this team seems to express that.
Yeah, they're exuding some confidence. They played well in practice yesterday and in a serve and pass this morning. They look ready to go.
On the other side, you have a Baylor team doing unprecedented things in the Big 12 Conference under fourth-year head coach Ryan McGuire. They have essentially developed into a true contender in that conference, and so they are going to be a force to be reckoned with.
They really have. They have a chip on the shoulder. They lost last year in the second round. They want to go further this year. They're looking for to pick a fight, so to speak. And so they're very athletic, and they're really strong, well-coached by Ryan McGuire. And this is just a solid team all the way around, top to bottom.
All right, so take us into the keys for the match. How is it going to work in the favor of either Hawaii or Baylor in this one?
Well, for Hawaii, they've got to slow Baylor's offense. And I think they're going to have to do that by serving tough and in to force bad passes, get Baylor out of system, then they have a chance. And for Baylor, they've got to get off to a fast start. When they win the first set, they win the match 82% of the time. When they lose the first set and get off to a slow start, they only win 50% of the time.
Here's a look at the bracket for Hawaii. This is that lower right quadrant that Hawaii is participating in. Baylor, of course, here. We are being hosted by 15 seed Oregon. They'll take on New Mexico State at the conclusion of this match. And then over in Minneapolis, Minnesota hosting Bryant, South Carolina, and Colorado making up the other matchup there. Some of the other bracket look. Top seed Stanford running away with the Pac-12 conference this year. They'll take on Alabama State. Loyola Marymount will take on Duke. You got Tennessee and Colorado State. And then Washington State, the 16 seed, taking on Northern Arizona. And Ryan McGuire was none too happy about the fact that Baylor was not among the seeded teams to play host, just missing out as the 17th rated team according to the latest RPIs. 9th seeded Creighton taking on South Dakota. You have St. Mary's in Washington, Syracuse, Yale, and number 8 Penn State going up against Howard. And we'll take you through at least one more here. Number 5 Texas, Stephen F. Austin. Texas State getting past Rice, and then you have Michigan and Navy, and 12 seed Pittsburgh going up against Iona. But we focus our attention here at the Matthew Knight Arena in Eugene. The starting lineup for Hawaii, here are the outside hitters: McKenna Granato, Noreen Yosia, who will also still double as a setter, Casey Castillo as well, one of the attackers for the Rainbow Wahine. Bit of a surprise in the middle as Skylar Williams getting the start for the Rainbow Wahine. She was looked upon much more down the stretch of the season. She'll join Natasha Burns at the middle position, Faith Ma'afala at center, and Tita Aku, a first-team All-Big West Conference selection at the libero position. Yasiana Presley, Gia Milana, Taylor Marburger. Three of the starters for Baylor: Shelly Fanning, Jalen Jackson, Hannah Locken, and Tara Wolf, the walk-on libero for the Bears. Baylor featuring two first-team All-Big 12 selections in Presley and Fanning. Both of them unanimous selections. Both of them second-time first-team selections. And it will be the Bears serving first. Taylor Marburger, the 5'5 sophomore from McAllen, Texas, 16 aces on the year, will put the volleyball into play, and we're about to get going here in the national postseason CMAC.
You can feel the tension in the arena.
And the first serve goes into the twine.
There's some tension right there on the first serve.
Baylor coming in with a 19-8 overall record, 11-5. They finished second in the Big 12 Conference behind perennial power there, Texas. On the other side, the Rainbow Wahine, 18-8 overall. They finished second in the Big West at 14-2, losing to Cal Poly and UC Santa Barbara. So McKenna Granato puts it in play from Hawaii's end, and the middle set goes to Jalen Jackson, 6'3 redshirt junior from South Chesterfield, Virginia, has been hampered with injury for 3 years, and now she's balling out.
Oh, she is so happy to be in there. She's got a heavy arm and a big block.
So Hawaii now on the attack. They go outside to Casey Castillo off the block. Little patty cake at the net, and Hawaii now on the attack again. Castillo a second time going off the fingertips. Dug up by Tara Wolf. And then Presley from off the net, dug up nicely by Tita Aku. Middle set goes to Burns, but she missed the court wide. And it is a point for the Ducks. For the Bears, I should say, 2-1 in favor of Baylor. So here is Wolf, team leading 25 aces on the year, puts it in play, and we're going to have a net violation called against Hawaii. So a bit of a sputtering start here early on for the Lady Bulls.
And pass by Granato just a little bit too tight to the net. Faith Maafala rubbed her shoulder against it for the violation.
Q handles the pass. They go backside this time. They're Noreen Yosia. The dink shot sniffed out by Gia Milana. Here's Yasiana Presley off the block. That one saved over the net. Presley wasn't ready for it, and she got handcuffed by it, and Hawaii scoots by with a freebie.
She wasn't a blocker there, so she couldn't contact it twice. She was standing on the ground, so a non-blocker does not get a chance to touch it twice, and hence Hawaii gets the point.
So two serving three. Middle set, and that is Shelly Fanning. We will be calling her name a lot tonight. 6'2 redshirt junior from Cypress, Texas, has been playing through a stress fracture in her left leg, has it heavily wrapped there, and so they limit her jumps per day, per workout. And yet she's been out there start after start.
And she rides a scooter the rest of the workout, hence the nickname Scooty.
And there's Skylar Williams in the middle, getting it down for Hawaii, averaging 1.19 kills per set, hitting 327.
Nice pass by Q. Sky Williams skying for that one, hitting over that big Baylor block.
Here's Yosia, blasts it deep and long. That is certainly one of the points of emphasis for this Hawaii team in this match, C-Mac. Is it not serve tough and try to test these Baylor serve receivers?
Exactly, and more importantly, serve in to see how their ball handling skills are.
Hawaii goes outside. It's Castillo, solo blocker up, and Hannah Locken gets the best of it. The starting setter was an AVCA honorable mention a year ago as a true freshman. And she gets in on her 45th block of the season. Outserve, though, from Yasiana Presley, and Hawaii gets the point.
Hawaii's going to watch out for Yasiana Presley now in the back row. She might be more effective hitting out of the back than the front. She is a leaper, touches 10-9.
Led the Big 12 Conference in kills per set. She's averaging 4.8 for the second straight season. Rico Aquino with the serve, and that goes into the twine. Well, you can't test the passers unless you get that serve in.
Exactly. That's what I was going to say. Hawaii's really got to make sure that they test the passers by keeping as many serves in as possible.
Here's Fanning. Slaps it across. Good pass there by Aquino. And Williams in the middle. Heavy-handed there. It results in a free chance here for Hawaii. Backside. It's Angel Gaskin off the block. Played up nicely by Fanning. And then on the outside, Ania Philo is dug up. Here's McKenna Granato. Did she get a touch? No touch. She goes out with it, and it's a point for the Bears. Baylor, notoriously strong starters in matches, whereas this season, Hawaii has been notoriously slow to start matches.
Not a good combination for Hawaii.
Short serve results in the overpass, but a good dig there by Aquino. Granato from off the net. Chance here for the Bears on the attack. They go to Jackson in the middle. Didn't get all of it. So Aquino bump sets Gaskin off the double block. Played up nicely by Brea Hunt. But a double hit against the Bears, and it's a point for the Rainbow Wahine. A scrappy point at that.
That's the kind of long rallies I think Hawaii will be the beneficiary of with their superior ball handling skills. But right now, on the scoreboard, Baylor up 8-5 because of their size.
Janelle Gong with the serve. Outside set. That's Philo, and she's blocked and roofed. Natasha Burns up there next to Angel Gaskin, denying access. Burns, the team leader in that category, 1.07 blocks per set.
Coming off all the first all Big West selection.
First in her career, one of four Rainbow Wahine players to receive first team all Big West honors. And how about that fireball from Yasiana Presley? And as you mentioned, one of the great leapers in all of college volleyball.
She really gets up high. Watch this. Great set from Lockham. She almost lands at the net.
So Hawaii trailing by three. High ball bump set goes to Granato, and she's dug up by Wolf. Here's Philo. Tried to swipe at it. She missed it, and it's a point for the Rainbow Wahine. She's trying to keep pace here. Hawaii making it to the NCAA tournament against some odds. At least that was the appearance as they were trudging low in the RPI rankings for a vast majority of the season, but they get in. It's their 26th straight NCAA appearance and 37th overall. That one hit long by Milana, and it's a point for Hawaii.
Gia Milana, former teammate of Angel Gaskin from Hawaii, both of them transferring out of Maryland to brand new schools because of the coaching change.
So a 4-1 burst here by the Rainbow Wahine. Both teams flatlining it in hitting percentage thus far. That one dug up by Okino. Cross court bump set. Granato got under it. And no touch on the play, so it's a point for the Bears.
Granato usually a sure swinger on those sets from the back row. She's got such a great arm swing. Struggling to kind of find her grip rhythm right now. Badly missing two shots, one down the line, one over the block.
Yeah, four attempts, no kills, two errors so far for Mack. It's a good serve there by Marburger. Opportunity knock in here for Baylor. Back bump set, Presley through the block and down. Her second kill. Two-time unanimous all Big 12 first team selection. And she gave Hawaii headaches when these two teams met in Honolulu last season, if you remember, as part of the Outrigger Resorts Wahine Volleyball Challenge. Hawaii won in five, but Presley with 18 kills hit 359.
And Granato finally gets off the schneid, gets her first kill. Still hitting negative, though, but gets her first kill at a crucial part of the game, not letting the Baylor Bears run away and hide.
Yeah, you get the feeling Hawaii's still trying to settle into this thing a little bit. Playing on this busy hardwood floor. Hawaii, of course, normally playing on TerraFlex. Baylor plays on hardwood, so a little more familiar perhaps with the surface, and that's a good swing there by Noreen Yosia.
Nice little side set by Yosia. And how about the serve by Granato, which forced the overpass? Let's see if Granato serves Tara Wolf again.
10 serving 11 here in a back and forth set number one. Granato into the twine.
There's three Hawaii service errors so far. They just cannot let that stat run up and get too large, otherwise they're not going to have a chance in this first set.
Here's Tara Wolf. Castillo from off the net. That's a good swing on it, but a great up by Wolf. Outside, Presley comes soaring in right there to pick it is a cue. Yosia from off the net. That one dug up by Lockin. So the swing by Milana off the fingertips. Faith Ma'afala middle set to Natasha Burns. Layout save Philo and a free chance here for Hawaii. Can they catch it in? Castillo straight down to the floor.
Nice transition play by Hawaii that time. That time, Faith Ma'afala setting all three front row hitters, keep getting everybody involved. Hence, one blocker only for Castillo.
11 serving 12, it's a cue with the serve. Middle, that goes to Fanning, played over the net by Yosia. Fanning swings at it out of midair, and it's dug up by a cue. Baylor now on the attack. Here's Presley, blocked and roofed. Skylar Williams saying, a ole, and this opening set is tied.
What a block. Finally, they found a way to slow down Presley.
Baylor out of system, so chance here for Hawaii. Back set to Yosia. Two-handed in the air by Wolf. Presley winds up, uncoils, and uncorks one through that Hawaii block.
I think she's got only two speeds, Kanoa. Hard and harder. What do you think? She's special, isn't she?
Well, that means she only has two jumps also, high and higher.
Yeah.
Yeah, her number's phenomenal. Backside, here's Yosia. Solo blocker up was Presley. So a good decision made there by the center, Faith Ma'afala, getting that one-on-one matchup.
Well, that was a tight set. I'm surprised Presley didn't just push this straight back down. She picked the wrong spot to go. Should have taken Yosia's cross-court instead on a tight set.
That's a 5-2 run being experienced here by Hawaii. And this opening set is very much up for grabs, C-Mac, but those service errors are starting to haunt Hawaii. They are coming at inopportune times, and that's number four in this opening frame. Presley with the serve. Sends it down the line flat-footed. Good pass there by Granato. The set to Gaskin. Tried to dink it over. Here's Presley from the back row. Blocked back. Philo now slaps it across. A cue. Back bump set to Castillo. She's blocked. So Williams sets up Casey. Blocked again. Hawaii trying to stay with it here. Granato from the back row. Diving save Presley. Good sequence. Here's Philo. Got it in on that end line. The Hawaii bench didn't necessarily agree with the call, but it is Baylor hitting 15 first. They lead by two. Welcome back. Let's check out the First Hawaiian Bank top three. This is the list for NCAA Women's Volleyball Tournament appearances. Hawaii, we mentioned, this is their 37th overall, just one behind Stanford and Penn State. The infamous 1992 year where Hawaii injury-plagued, missed out on the tournament. That still remains the only season in which Hawaii did not advance to the dance. Out of the timeout, it's Baylor by two. You'll see it with the bump set to Gaskin, blocked and roofed. That is a big block put up by Shelly Fanning.
Fanning at 6'2". The redshirt junior, one of the better blockers on the team, leads them in block assists and block solos.
Out serve, Presley thought she had curled it in, but just missed long, and so Hawaii a much needed point. Rainbow Wahine hitting 080 here in this opening frame, 107 for the Bears prior to that timeout. Backside, and that's Fanning down the line, and she got it in. So Shelly Fanning getting a swing from the opposite position near the pin, C-Mac.
Yeah, they like to move her wherever they can in order to get her more swings. So she hits 401 on the air, so she rarely misses.
Here's Gaskin, the touch shot, played up by Philo. From the back row, it's Presley off the block and down. And now some distance for the Bears. 5-1 run, it is 18 serving 14.
The Bears did a great job that time, taking a broken play and making it into a good one. Presley can save them so many times, that leaping ability of her.
Outside, here's Granato. Cross court, right there is Philo. And Presley from the back row, right to that middle area of the floor. Largest lead of this opening stanza for the Baylor Bears. They lead 19-14, and that prompts Robin Amo Santos to signal for a timeout. We'll take a break as well. The Bears growling. Well, Yasiana Presley, she's been all she's cracked up to be so far. 5 kills hitting 400, Chris.
She averages 4.8 on the year, so already we're only halfway through the first set. And she is at her average. Hawaii's got to find some way to slow her down.
Baylor's starting to bump up the hitting percentage overall. They're at 179 now. Hawaii below the 100 mark at .065. That timeout signaled by Robin Amo Santos came when Baylor extended the lead to the largest yet in this opening frame. That service error, though, gives the side and the point to Hawaii. So 15 serving 19.
Point Amo Santos.
Outside, here's Philo. Nice play down the line there by Yosia. Granato has to time the high ball, goes off the block and down. Well, there is no secret that in order for Hawaii to pull this off, McKenna Granato is going to have to do her thing.
Exactly. Hawaii gets inspired by the senior. Her experience is so valuable.
Oh, pancake save, Okino. You'll see it tried to catch it to that deep corner, but it's Presley firing from the back row again. Kill number six for Yasiana Presley.
She's firing from the back row, and she's on fire. Great pancake dig there by Eriko Okino.
It ends with the laser beam once again from Presley. Here's Granato, blocked out a piece. And then the roof, solo style by Natasha Burns, victimizing Jaylen Jackson that time.
Boy, picks up block number three as Burns reaches over and slams that one down. Might have gotten a lot of cable, too. Natasha, one of the most improved players on this Rainbow Wahine team.
17 serving 20. Presley from the back row caught it fat. It goes long. Hawaii back within two.
You know, her last swing might have gone out too, except Hawaii got a back row player that got in the way of the ball. It just arrived so fast. She hits the ball with heat.
So here's Ma'afala. Always takes that extended breath before sending it across. It's shanked by Wolf, and that's an ace. And that's a point for Hawaii. Their first ace of this match, and it comes at the most needed time. Timeout, Ryan McGuire and the Baylor Bears. A 5-1 Hawaii run, and that one came in our area.
Ryan McGuire seeing the wheels coming off a little bit. What a good coach he has been over the years.
In his fourth season, 2017 Big 12 Coach of the Year. And they have started to accomplish things that this program has never accomplished. The fact that they are finishing so high in the conference standings. The fact that they have been ranked so high. They peaked out at 12th in the nation this year in the national rankings. That was highest in program history.
Yeah, and three out of 4 years he's taken them to the NCAA playoffs. First year he said was a little sketchy when he got there, but they've really got a good thing going. Nice, positive volleyball culture going. He had six NAIA titles when he coached at Cal Baptist, so he's used to playing in big tournaments like this, for sure.
Well, let's get into our Jack Fact. Regionally successful, Hawaii has a combined record of 47-6 against teams in the Eugene Regional. The Bows are 6-0 versus Baylor, 7-4 versus Oregon, and 34-2 against New Mexico State. Remember the last time Hawaii and Baylor met up, as we mentioned, in Honolulu last year for the Outrigger Challenge. And that was a thriller of a match, Hawaii winning in five. But what's interesting about this is, you know, we've already seen Tita Aku, Angel Gaskin. We have yet to see Sarah Leva here in this match. But the senior transfers for this Rainbow Wahine squad playing in the NCAA tournament for the first time in their careers. Just sort of adding to the experience.
I talked to them last night at the hotel. They are so excited. They're the only ones in the team who have never played in this event.
Philo blocked back. Presley giving chase. And a free ball coming for Hawaii, looking to tie this set. Burns hammers it down.
What a comeback. Down 19-14, scrambling all the way back to tie it up.
Some of the Hawaii following that made the trek to Eugene, Oregon. Going to turn up the volume knob a bit. Here's Philo, the dink. Good up there by Okino. Here's Granato at the fingertips of the block. So Wolf will set up Milana from off the net and was able to poke it through that block and down. Gia Milana, the 6'2 junior from Michigan.
Faith Ma'afala on the back right. just overruns this player. Is that Yosiya? It was Mafala.
Yeah, Yosiya actually getting a piece on the block there on that swing. And the out serve ties it up again.
An aggressive serve that time by Tanner Marburger. Number three in service aces for this team. No wonder. She puts a good pop on it.
So here's Granato. She had 22 kills and 13 digs for what it's worth against Baylor last year. Good pass there by Wolf. Presley off of a trampoline. Straight down on that kill.
Boy, does she get up or what? Gets up, hangs, and hammers.
24 double-figure kill matches for Presley this season. She's almost got double figures here in the opening set. Seven for her. Castillo off the block. And that's going to result in a point for Hawaii. Good effort there on the Bears' side of the net. And we're tied at 22.
We've got a barn burner here already. And we're only half hour into this.
Here's a cube, floats it deep. They go outside to Presley, and she catches that end line. That is kill number eight for Yasiana Presley.
I'm sensing that Locken knows that Presley's got the hot hand. She's feeding her every chance that she can.
And without wasting any time, Robin Amosantos signals for the timeout. She wants to talk things over. I think she realizes, hey, look, we're going up against the team 25th in the country, and we are in this opening set. Boy, it would be quite the accomplishment and statement if Hawaii was able to pull this first stanza off.
And how about Presley with eight kills, hitting 429?
That's amazing.
Huge numbers.
UH Athletics reaches out to you online each week with updates and promotions through its HMail e-newsletter. To register, visit HawaiiAthletics.com and click on the HMail button. It's simple and it's free.
To put in perspective, for the year, Yasiana Presley hits 213. So she's doubling her kill percentage, making very few errors. Eight kills, only two errors and 14 swings. And she's going to get more and more sets as the night goes on, because I'll tell you, Hannah Locken can really feel that Presley has got the hot hand.
This is a Baylor team, though. We've talked about some of the injuries that have gone around. Players playing through them, but having to shift the lineup around all year, Ryan McGuire has been able to create some depth, and he, like Robin Amosantos, is not one to hesitate when a change is necessary. But I think his concern coming into the tournament, at least what he told us, is I feel like we are coming out of the preseason as opposed to the regular season. We haven't, because of the injuries, been able to really calibrate ourselves to being NCAA tournament ready as they head into this one.
Exactly. They've had 10 out of 17 players on the sidelines with injuries. Six out of their seven starters have been hurt.
Baylor by one. Here's Yosiya, a big block against her. It was Presley, but she pressed up against the net. And so a point for Hawaii. It's 23 all. It is anybody's opening set right
guess,
now.
Guess where the next set's going to go? I think Fanning or Presley, but probably Presley.
Yosiya, she can score from the service line. Perfect pass, though, by Wolf. It goes outside. Presley, the dink. She's blocked and roofed. Williams and Gaskin. Block number four for Hawaii. And a timeout taken by the Bears.
Nice hang time by Angel Gaskin that time.
And so it is Aloha ball in favor of Hawaii here in set number one.
Like I said, Ryan McGuire has been in this situation many, many times in his coaching career. He coached at Biola, coached at Cal Baptist, he's been at North Carolina State. He's run up quite the impressive record all that time. And he does have a Hawaii connection, doesn't he?
That's right. His wife, Jen Roberts, former Rainbow Wahine middle hitter, unable to make the trip over from Waco, Texas.
Somebody's got to watch the children,
I guess so. We got three children who Ryan McGuire describes as a handful. You see the Hawaii following here.
Jen McGuire's probably getting a little nostalgic, at least watching all the Hawaii fans that made this trip. Probably reminds her of the days when she played for the University of Hawaii.
Well, it is aloha ball for the Rainbow Wahine in set one. How big would this be, whoever comes away with this opening set win? Rotations being checked. And now we're ready on set point. Yosia with the serve. Pass by Wolf. They go outside. Presley, but it's off the net. She's blocked. She'll get a second crack at it. She's blocked again. And it's a free ball coming for Hawaii. Yosia, backside. Gaskin. Played up by Granato to keep it alive. Castillo slaps it deep. Bears now with the advantage. Here's Presley. Dug up by Granato. Here's Casey. Two-handed in the air there by Philo. High ball set. Presley, the roll shot. Pinballed around and returned. How about this sequence? Presley again sends it long. Was there a touch? No touch. Point Hawaii. And they take set number one.
There's going to be a challenge, I think. Ryan McGuire reached for the challenge card. There's going to be a challenge in that last swing.
That's right. Hold the phone. Hold the phone. After much contention from the players on the floor, Ryan McGuire was convinced to bust out the challenge card. So the review system works very similarly to what we experience back in Honolulu with the TV games in the Big West Conference. And so each side gets three challenges. You get an extra one if it goes to a fifth set. And so most certainly this challenge will be regarding whether or not there was a touch on this swing by Presley, because it most certainly goes long, but it was on the side of the Baylor Bears where there was a lot of gesticulating from the players saying there should have been a touch call, there should have been a touch call.
Well, the ball is definitely out. That's not a question at all. It's to see if Hawaii touched it on the block. I didn't see a change in the spin of the ball. Hard to tell if there's a touch on one of the fingers. This is a very difficult thing to see in this kind of slow motion.
We got Bill Forrester, the R2. He is an extremely experienced official who is reviewing this replay.
Yeah, he's very experienced. He's been to Hawaii many times.
And we have said it time and time again, ad nauseum, the touch replays, the touch or no touch challenge is probably the most difficult to determine of all of the challenges.
Yeah, it looked like Angel Gaskin's right pinky on her right hand might have bent back. That's what I saw just
there.
Is
there enough there now becomes the question. It has to be conclusive in terms of the evidence to overturn what was an out call. So this is huge. This is either a point and set for Hawaii, or we're tied at 24.
Yeah. Well, he's sure reviewing it enough times, isn't he? He's making sure he knows how crucial this call is.
Yeah, from that angle, I think that is the one that creates the most uncertainty.
Yeah. But like you said, if it's uncertain, they've got to stick with the original call.
Well, the headset has come off. Just adding a little drama, as if we didn't have enough here on the opening day of the NCAA tournament.
Looks like, I bet it's a no touch.
It's a point for Hawaii, and they take set number one. Monstrous statement by the Rainbow Wahine against nationally ranked Baylor. But we got a whole lot of volleyball left to play in Eugene.
This presentation of Rainbow Wahine Volleyball is sponsored by Bank of Hawaii, and Hawaii Honda dealers.
Well, the middles factor pivotally in that opening frame to Rasha Burns and Skylar Williams for Hawaii, C-Mac.
Yeah, they only got 5 out of the 41 sets, but they got to get on a couple of blocks like that, making life miserable for the outside hitters for the Baylor Bears.
Skylar Williams, the decision was made by Robin Omosantos to start Skylar in the middle. She had turned to her more frequently at the beginning of matches late in the season, even though Sarah Leva was pegged primarily as the other starter next to Natasha Burns. But Robin has done this, right? She's gone off of feeling. She has gone off the vibe.
Exactly.
And she goes with Skylar Williams, and it certainly paid off in that opening frame.
Yeah, I think part of it was probably size and length up at the net. Leva, so athletic, brings so much offense. But I think Robin Omosantos was more worried about defense at the net and blocking. But how about the person who's leading the Bows in attacking? Their setter, Yosia. 3 kills, no errors, and 7 tries, hitting a mere 429.
So the team swaps sides. A huge statement for Hawaii taking set one. But a whole lot of volleyball left as Gia Milana goes right back to work off the block and into the pin for a Baylor point. Baylor hit 114 in that opening set compared to 146 for the Rainbow Wahine, but Hawaii closed the first frame on a 4-1 run to win it 25-23. Here's Granato, double block up against her. Here's Presley, block out a piece, but there's not much that Granato could do there. She was caught somewhat flat-footed under the net, and Presley just jumped over.
She gets up. I remember she touches 10-9. She can dunk a volleyball. Major hops. 9 kills to lead all attackers.
Oh, follow those middle to Burns. Little joust at the net. Hawaii scrambling. And Granato two hands it over. Burns with a free crack at it, and she takes advantage.
A little bit of patty kick up there at the net as Granato had to just keep the ball in play, put it in a nice spot, which forced the overpass. Smart play by Granato, and then Burns finishes.
Yeah, that last sequence looked like the kind of volleyball you see played in a pool.
Yeah, that's right.
And that's an ace. Granato, she's as surprised as anybody.
Looked to me like it came off the side of her thumb. I'm not sure it was a really clean hit, but it worked out well. It was way more left than I think she anticipated. They're trying to serve Milana.
That time it works out of system, but Presley, she can cover up a lot of errors, dug up nicely there by Ma'afala, though, but the block is up. Shelly Fanning denying access.
Fanning so strong at the net, not only good offensively, hitting 401 for the year, but how about her 117 block assists and 7 block solos? She is just one terrific player, former All-American.
And we mentioned playing through the injury, and we're talking about a stress fracture in her lower leg. She has started every match this season despite that. Castillo, layout saved there by Philo in the back row, centered by Presley, and a free ball coming. Outside, Castillo. And we'll have a net violation. Casey coming into the twine.
Set a little bit too tight to the net. Castillo tried to pull her on back, but not in time. It's like a rerun of the first set, in case you just joined us. Baylor jumping out to a 4-2 lead as they did in set one.
Baylor led by as many as 5, 19-14 in that first set, and Hawaii was still able to pull it out 25-23. And if you're just joining us, Kanoa Leahy, Chris McLaughlin here. Matthew Knight Arena on the campus of the University of Oregon, playing host to this sub-regional opening round of the NCAA tournament. Fanning, great layout save there by a Q. And then Yosia goes through the block. That is Fanning and Presley on the block. And Noreen is able to scoot it by him.
Oh, she just continues to do it with smoke and mirrors. Look at a Q with the save, giving up her body. And Yosia finishing.
Outside, here's Presley. The dink. Diving save, Ma'afala. A cue from one knee. Back bump sets Castillo, and she goes hard angle and in. How about that set by Tita Aku?
A blind back bump set, one of the toughest things to do in the game. And Akiu does it with perfection. And Castillo, meantime, buries it.
Cross-court bump set to Presley. Couldn't really get much behind it. So chance for Hawaii. It's Williams in the middle, block out a piece. That's Fanning. Quick middle set there from Lockett. They've done that a few times the last couple of seasons.
Fanning had one monster game this year against West Virginia. 20 kills, no errors in 27 tries. A new school record. Hit 741.
Tops in the Big 12 this year in hitting percentage as Yosiah continues to climb the numbers in that category as well. That's five kills for Noreen. She's hitting over 500.
And this is not something you expect every night out of Noreen because she's so valuable with her serving, her defense, her setting. So often she is like the third choice in hitting, but right now she's got to be the first choice of any setter.
She's carrying the load. Fanning into the twine.
A rare error. That's like snow in Waikiki. My goodness. Fanning never misses. Do you think I botched her when I said 20 kills, no errors against West Virginia? And she shows up with a horrible error there. Not a great shot by arguably their best player.
Yosiah sends it wide on the serve, and so the point goes to the Bears. Well, we talked about the psychology here behind these two teams, right? Ryan McGuire, the head coach for Baylor, saying, you know, I feel like we were a bit disappointed that we didn't get a chance to host in the sub-regional rounds. As Gaskin hammers it down. Whereas on the other side, you have a Hawaii team that was just thankful to even get in. There were some doubts as to whether or not they'd be playing at this time of year. And so here they are. And so you're talking about two different perspectives from a mentality standpoint.
Absolutely. But, you know, he did something to talk to his team to get them thinking in the reverse because they were so lively at practice, lively in warm-ups, were showing no signs of negative attitude.
The block, Skylar Williams. Solo deal. And Hawaii up three.
And Sky coming up with their third block of the night against the most prolific player on the court, Yasiana Presley. She's now got, she gets every other set basically. She had 20 out of 44 sets.
Joust at the net after the overpass. Here's Philo down the line and wide. No touch point Hawaii. And they're up four here in set number two. Ryan McGuire cannot wait for the media timeout. He signals for one, and they're going to talk things over. An 8-2 run for Hawaii. Welcome back. Let's go inside the numbers presented by Heineken. 115, the all-time NCAA tournament matches for Hawaii. 81 wins, 33 losses. That is a winning clip of 71%. Of course, Hawaii with three NCAA national championships, 82, 83, and 87. Back in 79, it was an AIAW title. But they find themselves up one set to none on 25th-ranked Baylor and up 10-6 here in set two. And a good dig there by Akiu. Renato Rochaw from off the net got it blocked right back. Williams in the middle tried to slice it to the angle but missed it wide. And a point for the Bears.
Boy, Hawaii had their chances in that rally to score the point. Got a good swing there at the end. But give the Bears credit for making some terrific digs and staying in that rally. But they're struggling offensively. Three kills, three errors, hitting 0-0-0 this set.
Middle set, Williams unable to get it down. Dug up by Hannah Flegel, who has checked into the match. But the roof is up. Skylar Williams is putting up the wall on the Rainbow Wahine side of the net.
Sky is everywhere. She goes skying there, right there, to put that one down. Boy, leading in block 6-3 on the Big Baylor Bears.
Here's Janelle Gong with the serve. And that's set to Philo. She tried to get cute with it, but didn't get it over the net. We have seen now a change at the setter position instituted by Ryan McGuire. As mentioned, Hannah Flegel, 5'10 junior. From out of California. She's a walk-on, referred to by McGuire as the quote-unquote Rudy of the team. She's that kind of underdog story. And a great job there, a couple of swings by Gia Milano. But what do you think he's trying to accomplish there with the setter change?
You know, it could be tempo, it could be rhythm, could be location. You'd like to see a better location. I'm not sure I would have pulled the plug that early on Locken. You know, Locken's a solid player. She was feeding Presley quite well, and those two had a nice connection going on. But obviously, Ryan McGuire did not like something there, so I'm afraid to put in a new setter.
Serve there by Chanel Bramschreiber, and Gaskin curls it in.
How did that one go in? It looked to me like it was a spat shot, no spin. It was going to go flying out to the first row instead. It somehow found a way to drop.
Angel Gaskin, one of those players that you've seen the development in all season long. She's playing her best volleyball now when it counts.
She really is. Got her parents out from back east to show support.
Here's Yosiya, double block up, and she's roofed. Jalen Jackson got the gist of that one.
Yosiya's first error of the night, 5 kills, leading all Rainbow Wahine. And her first error, solid block by the Baylor Bears there, though, reaching over the net and down.
I mean, arms everywhere above the tape on that one. Good look there from the net cam. Here's Granato, double block up again. Maafala goes middle to Burns. She got it. Just caught a piece of that sideline. And Hawaii up a handful again.
I think there might be another challenge going on here on the line call.
We will have another challenge. And Ryan McGuire, who has to explicitly state what part of that play he is challenging, appears as though he's going to challenge the in-out call. It would be his second of three, unless this were to go to a fifth. And a long conversation here between McGuire and Bill Forrester.
There are some close plays at the net there. I'm not sure that Granato didn't run into the net or step under the center line during that rally.
Maybe weighing his options?
I've never seen this long a discussion between the challenger and the referee.
This is clearly the longest I've ever seen. And it looks like it's still going. I mean, it's either you challenge it or you don't.
It's in-out line call, I think.
All right, so now we are getting the challenge.
Yep, it's in-out line call. Very interesting.
I mean, you do have the option of pinpointing a certain sequence or a certain point within that play to issue the challenge, but it looks like he will challenge the in-out call, and it looked like
that's
he got a piece
close
of the line, at least from that angle.
Very close. I see they back it up and slow it down. Yeah, there it is. Yep. That looks like pretty obvious call.
But yeah, perhaps he was intending on challenging another part of that play and was trying to see, you know, what was reviewable, what wasn't reviewable. But I've never seen a dialogue like that between the R2 and a head coach prior to a challenge. And it goes the way of Hawaii. Ryan McGuire now 0-for-2 in challenges.
Yeah, I think he was, Neil Canoa, I think you're right. I think he was probably asking Bill Forrester, what's reviewable? Is it reviewable if a player's across the center line or bumping into the net or whatever it was that Granato was doing?
So 14 serving 9. Granato doing the honors. Middle set, Fanning dug up by Castillo. Maafala goes high ball outside to Casey. Great up there by Philo. Here's Presley. Fingertips got a piece. You'll see a scrambling. Bump sets Granato from the back row. Chance here for the Bears. They go middle to Fanning, and she finds the floor.
I'll tell you, when Fanning and Presley are in the front row, that's a nightmare for Hawaii's middle blockers. No time for Burns having to worry about 4-1 hitter, and also having to worry about Presley on the outside, who's been on fire. Great swing by Fanning there to end that rally.
And it is Brea Hunt with the serve. Outside set, Castillo blocked back, punched over by a Q. Fanning again in the middle. Got a piece of the tape there. Now it's Yosia, double block up, and she gets it by.
And she's going up against two very good blockers in Presley and Fanning, and she just challenges them. Great bump set from Akia. Give her some credit there too, but so much power from Yosia goes right through the block as if it was a field goal.
Presley from off the net went over the block that time.
Ball might have been out by Malfala.
Chance here for Baylor. They go back row set. And that's Philo going off the block and down. Getting back to Noreen Yosia. She made it onto the All-Big West Conference first team for the third straight year, but this one was a bit different because in the first 2 years, she was a full-time setter. And this year, that is only part of her duties for this team as Presley goes long on the serve.
Yeah, it really was a tribute to her all-around volleyball athletic ability, volleyball IQ, and her value to the team. She's tremendously valued when Hawaii changed system from her, you know, from a 5-1 to a 6-2.
That'll be one of the interesting decisions and storylines next season is what Hawaii does at the setter position if you keep Noreen Yosia as a part-time hitter. If you put her back to a full-time setter. Here's Presley from the back row. It goes long. Was there a touch? No touch. Point Hawaii. And this is the Rainbow Wahine's largest lead of set two. And a timeout taken by Ryan McGuire. He is desperately searching for a spark. Hawaii right now, up a half dozen. Welcome back. Noreen Yosia leading the way for the Rainbow Wahine C-Mac. Sitting 455.
Amazing numbers for a setter turned hitter. She just finds different creative ways to get the ball to the floor, including challenging big blocks like that.
I mean, she rarely has the advantage at point of contact against the blockers that she's going up against, and yet she finds a way consistently.
Yeah. You can't overlook the digging by Akiu, the dozen digs by Akiu so far.
And here is Akiu now with the bump set to Gaskin. Roll shot. Diving save there by Hunt. Diving save by Granato right back at you. Here's Castillo off the fingertips. Philo. Block out a piece. Hawaii on the attack. Outside. Castillo gets it to go. Hawaii up 18-11.
I'll tell you what made that play, Cano, is the fact that Sky Williams went really hard in that last play. It looked like that Yosia was going to set the middle, and she did not. Gave Castillo a one-on-one on the outside.
Wolf overpass. Williams slams it down.
What a serve by Noreen Yosia. Forced that overpass. Wolf's been passing pretty steady, but that time just got away from her there.
Four straight points ripped off by the Rainbow Wahine. Largest lead of set two. Yosia keeping the pressure on with the serve. Philo off the block and out. Much needed point there for the Bears.
Philo struggled a bit tonight. Normally, you know, she's pretty solid. Tonight, though, that's her third kill. Four errors, hitting negative. Normally she'd have about half dozen kills by now. Instead, she just got three.
Started her career at Louisville. Has made quite a name for herself now in a Baylor uniform. Got a piece on that block as well. Here's Castillo against the double block. Punched over by Williams. Presley from the back row. Chance for Hawaii, a cue. Bump set to Gaskin, blocked back. Chased down on the second touch there by McKenna. And a free chance here for the Bears. Philo blocked and roofed.
What a block. Philo put a lot of heat on this ball. Sky Williams hustled to the outside and gets the block. It looked like it went off her head. What a great play.
That's now five blocks for Sky Williams. Seven total for the Lady Bows. And Rico Aquino with the serve. Philo says block that. That was a heater.
Philo, a sixth rotation outside hitter. All Big 12 last year. Great ball control.
Yeah, she had 20 digs last year when these two teams met up in Honolulu.
Missed her first three matches this year with a concussion. First in 3 years.
Wow. Good dig there by Presley, but only momentarily. As Milana couldn't back it up, give Granato the kill. Give Hawaii another point.
Quick, Granato's getting warmed up. Yosia's getting warmed up from behind the service line. Great bump set from Rika Okito. How about that?
And so now Janelle Gong in and back behind the line to serve. Six service aces on the season for her. Floats it over. Wolf puts the pass on the money, and then that delay middle set to Philo. Able to find that sideline. So Philo starting to factor a little more here in the Baylor offense. But it has been predominantly Yasiana Presley. But we actually have not heard much from her here in this last stretch.
And Baylor hitting a mere 0-0-0. Six kills, six errors.
Backside Gaskin. Great dig in the back row there by the Bears. Milana dug up. Here's Burns in the middle, block back. She pops it up herself, gets a second crack at it, and is roofed. Presley right up next to Jackson, closing the door.
How about the dig by Tara Wolf? Wow.
Timeout taken by Robin Amo-Santos. She doesn't like the way things were trending the last couple of points.
And I like this early timeout by Robin. You know, a lot of coaches will wait and wait and wait until the other team gets closer, but I like this timeout.
Well, one of the things that Hawaii's been able to do very well is they've been able to, up at the net, get a piece on a lot of the Baylor swings. And they've been able to get a lot of blocks and roofs, in fact, led by Sky Williams.
Yeah, she just is everywhere. Reaches a great length. Reaches up high, gets Presley on that one-on-one. Hustles to the outside and gets that one. Good footwork. And I think Angelica Yunkel is going to get some props here. She's been the middle blocking coach this year.
So that's the number for Sky Williams, 5. That's your Akamai Roofing Roof Report. The Rainbow Wahine Roofing Company, along with Akamai.
Nice sponsor.
Putting in some work here so far in this match.
Akamai to have that kind of a sponsor, don't you think?
I see what you did there. Beautiful facility here in Eugene, Oregon, the Matthew Knight Arena. Opened in 2011. Exceeding $200 million.
And it's got every whistle and bell, wouldn't you agree?
Oh, man. I mean, even in the bowels of the structure, which we got to know intimately when we were lost.
That's
trying
right.
to find our way to the court. But just beautiful. Everything is state-of-the-art. Here's a little bit of the scenics from outside.
I think our crew even had an easier time setting up because they've got plugs everywhere.
Of course, tremendous men's and women's basketball programs that play in this facility. As we return to live action, here's Granato off the block and down. Matthew Knight Arena, named after the late son of Phil Knight, the Nike founder.
Died young in a scuba diving accident.
That's right.
We haven't called Granato's name much tonight. That's because she's got 3 kills, 3 errors up until that point. She's been hitting 0.
Faith Ma'afala with the serve. Hawaii by 7. Milana sends it long. And that's a point for the Rainbow Wahine. And they are closing in on a 2-0 lead here in the match. 23 serving 15. Baylor hitting .029 in this second frame. Here's Presley. Should better that number a bit with her 10th kill of the match. So make it now 25 double-digit kill efforts for Presley on the year.
Stopping her there. She gets a good run up on that one. Hits it high and hard and over the block.
Tara Wolf with the serve. Aquino, great pass. Burns in the middle, just touches it over. Sniffed out by Milano. And then hammered home by Shelly Fanning. So a little bit of life coming from the Bears. Still got a tall hill to climb, though, trailing 17, serving 23.
Boy, can ill afford to let the Bears gain momentum going into set number three, because this is a really good Baylor team.
Mafala picks and chooses, goes backside to Granato. Dug up by Philo. Here's Presley. Good up by Mafala. Cross-court bump set, Yosia. Philo again with the pickup. Presley comes flying in off the block and down. And the Bears within a handful here. And you're right, it's not just watch out, the Bears could come back and win this set, which they very well can, but even from a momentum standpoint going into the rest of the match. Backside, Granato blocked and roofed. And the Bears are coming.
Fanning and Presley looking solid out there, forehands across and reaching over, penetrating that net. You get the net cam showing just how much they penetrate over. Great block by Baylor.
And that's now four straight Baylor points, 19 serving 23. Mafala goes outside, Yosia, fingertips of the block, got a piece. Fanning in the middle, handcuffed, somehow gets the kill, and Baylor within three. And Robin Amosantos signals for a timeout. Boy, did the complexion of this second set change in an instant.
Baylor passing better. They were able to run their middle, going to their 401 hitter, Fanning, the All-American. This is a good rotation, by the way, for this team. They've got Fanning, an All-American in the middle. Presley, you know, on the outside, who had 39 kills earlier this year, by the way, against Iowa State. So she's like a kill machine. All Big 12 last year, freshman of the year last year, and an All-American. So two All-Americans in the front row right now, making life difficult for the Rainbow Wahine.
And we, unfortunately and frankly, have seen this before from Hawaii, where they were up late in sets, gave up leads. In some instances, it led to them losing those sets. We saw that in the opener following that brilliant victory over Cal Poly at the Stan Sheriff Center, the opening set against UC Santa Barbara, where Hawaii blew a 24-20 advantage and then went on to lose that match.
Well, they get a chance to see if they learned anything from history by the way they play these next few points.
I mean, this is a golden opportunity for Hawaii. Already up 1-0. In this match.
What a difference to go up 2-0 or be tied 1-1.
Yeah.
Huge.
Especially when you had a 23-15 advantage in set two. So out of the timeout, where does Hawaii go to get out of this sticky rotation? Tara Wolf to serve. Hawaii will be out of system. It's Yosia against the double block into the net. Another point for Baylor. That's six straight. They're down two.
Hawaii's two-man passing pattern breaking down just a little bit here. Wolf really picking it apart, making those two passers work hard. Aquino and Akio.
Tries to pick on Aquino again, so it's Burns bump setting Yosia, and she hits it long. Another point for the Bears, and they are right there.
Like Granato's going to step back and help a little bit. So three people passing now.
Wolf sends it deep and out. Wow, a huge service error. You can't blame her, though. Quite a service run. But Baylor was on the precipice of tying this thing up. It is now Aloha ball in set two for Hawaii.
Oh. The shift in momentum in the game of volleyball.
Granato with the serve. Middle set, Fanning dug up by Aku. Mafala to Castillo, off the block, kept alive by Wolf. Here's Presley, off the block and out, point Baylor. It remains Aloha ball for Hawaii in the second. And you are seeing a drastic change in the body language on the Baylor side of the net.
Hawaii's got Castillo in the front row, Yosia and Burns. Mostly they need a good pass right here.
Brea Hunt floats it deep. Two-hand pass, Granato. Outside, Castillo finishes it with Definity. And Hawaii takes set two, 25-23. And can you imagine the Rainbow Wahine with an opportunity to crack open the broom closet in the first round of the NCAA tournament? Well, there is your score. There is your scenario. Hawaii pulling out a victory in sets one and two against the 25th-ranked Baylor Bears. Set three coming up. Can the Rainbow Wahine finish the deal? Well, here's a look at the match statistics. Hawaii taking the first two sets. The blocking numbers, though, eye-popping, C-Mac.
Yeah, Hawaii triple or doubling their normal output on blocks. But look at the offense. Neither team able to get it going. Hawaii hitting 121, Baylor hitting 128. Too many errors, some great defense being played, and you got to credit both coaches for having scouted the other team well.
Well, we talked about the opportunity that presented itself for this Rainbow Wahine team just getting into the field. How about the opportunity presenting itself now, up two sets to none on the Bears?
Well, they better keep on the gas pedal because this Baylor Bears team is really good. Baylor Bears are 1-4 on 0-2 starts this year, so that's not a good number for them. But I'll tell you, the way they finished that second set, they were on fire.
Well, we pinpointed the block and that category for Hawaii as part of the reason why they were able to jump out to this two-set lead. But what else have you seen in this Rainbow Wahine game tonight that you think has contributed to the position they're in at the moment?
Well, the unexpected offense from Noreen Yosia is one. And I think the other thing that's been big, obviously, has been the block. And then how about Akiu with her 15 digs? That's 7.5 digs per set. Normally she averages around 4.5 or 5, so she's up the ante there. That's made a huge difference.
Not bad for her very first NCAA tournament match in her career, the transfer from Texas Tech. Here's Philo from the back row, curled it over the net and down. Even she had to let out a bit of a sarcastic smirk as to the fortuitous ricochet on that one.
And she's been such a solid player for Baylor, even though she's undersized at 5'8". A good jumper, six rotation player. Hawaii's got to be careful of her getting off the Schneider and playing better. Well, that could have been a call.
Yeah, Presley is blocked and roofed. Burns next to Yosia saying uh-uh. We also see a change in the rotation on the Baylor side of the net. Marika Vandermark, 6'6", redshirt freshman from the Netherlands.
Maybe the largest player ever to put on a Baylor Bear uniform.
A lefty opposite as Fanning hammers it home. And some energy being displayed on the Baylor side of the floor. Vandermark now will be subbed out as Brea Hunt comes in.
They are an emotional team. They were in practice, they were in warm-ups, and they're very emotional right now.
Not scared to have fun in practice either. I mean, even on the eve of an NCAA tournament match, as Hunt sends it long, we saw Ryan McGuire having a little fun with them. He gets into the drills himself. He has funny names for some of the drills. When they get into sort of their last scrimmage-like drill of the practice, he says, "All right, guys, it's time for Sweat City."
That was fun. The girls loved it.
You'll see you into the net. So we are tied at 3 here early on in the third. Hawaii trailed 19-14 in the opening set, came back to win that one 25-23. Despite an 8-2 run to close things in the second set, Hawaii able to win 25-23 there as well, as Gaskin gets roofed by Fanning. And yeah, we're seeing smiles. That must have been, you would assume, part of the messaging between sets 2 and 3 was Ryan McGuire saying, "Hey, let's get back to enjoying ourselves."
Exactly. You see how they celebrate after each point. Meantime, Hawaii struggling to get a side out right now.
Set goes outside. It's Philo. What a save by Akiu. And she has to send a free ball the way of the Bears. Philo, block out a piece. Back bump set to Castillo. Tried to go off the block, didn't get any contact. It's a point for the Bears. We also see Hannah Locken back in at the center position for Baylor CMAC.
Yeah, it doesn't surprise me. Again, Ryan McGuire unafraid to move people in and out of the lineup depending on his feelings. This is kind of his gut feelings.
Out serve there by Presley. That's service error number 10 for Baylor compared to zero service aces for the Bears. Hawaii on a 6-2 ratio in that regard. Backside, Fanning, high hands and down. Another point of conversation may have been, hey, let's get Shelly more involved as well. Shelly Fanning has been given some opportunities here early in set three.
Well, she's an All-American. Anybody who hits 401 ought to be getting more sets for sure.
Williams, the set a bit low there. So the Bears playing it back the other way. Jackson didn't get all of it, got enough of it. And the Bears out in front, 7-4 here to start set three.
This looks like a rerun of set number one when the Bears jumped off to an early start.
5-1 burst by Baylor. Outside here is Granato. The dink works. And Hawaii gets out of that sticky rotation. Granato with 6 kills. So now Janelle Gong on to serve for the Rainbow Wahine. Oh, that one hammered home by Philo. She's starting to feel the rhythm. 7 kills for Ania Philo.
And Philo really gets up. No, she's 5'8". She turned down the line. She hit a sharp cross court. She got high hands. She's got all the tools.
One of just 2 seniors on this Baylor roster. They also have 7 juniors, 3 sophomores, and 5 freshmen. As Granato pumps it long, no touch. And Baylor with some breathing room here in set three and a fairly uninspiring opening to this third set by Hawaii. And observing that, Robin Amosanto signals for a timeout. Hawaii talking things over. Welcome back to Matthew Knight Arena on the campus of the University of Oregon. The opener of the NCAA tournament for Hawaii taking on number 25 Baylor. And the Rainbow Wahine up 2-0, but things trending a bit differently here in the third. As the Bears look lively on their side, Hawaii looking a little flat, trailing by 4. Burns the touch shot. Diving save there by Wolf. Here's Gaskin blocked. Great save there by Akiu to keep it alive. Roll shot by Granato, and right now it's the Bears picking everything up. Vandermark is dug up by Akiu. Here's Granato. Deep corner and in. Got it by the 6'6 length of Marika Vandermark.
Good swing by Gaskin, but a better block by Philo.
How about Tita Akiu? She has been a little bit of everywhere here in this match. She is playing lights out.
14 digs. On the other side of the net, Philo with 13 digs.
Philo with the dink. Good scramble by Hawaii just to keep it alive, but a free chance here for Baylor. It's Hannah Fliegel who sets up Philo, tools the block. Point for the Bears.
It looks like Ryan McGuire might be going with 2 setters, Fliegel and Locken this set.
What do you think about that idea?
Well, when you're down 0-2, it's time to try something different probably, but you know, they only lost by 4 points total in those 2 sets. I wouldn't push any panic buttons.
Nice save there by Okino. The dink by Granato. A couple of diving efforts and a free chance here for Hawaii. Here's Granato again by the double block and down. A perfect set there by Faith Ma'afala.
Credit Baylor for some great floor defense. They're diving everywhere for the ball. That time, a terrific set by Faith Ma'afala, giving Granato a one-on-one on the outside.
back row said. That's Philo, and she stepped on the line. A back row attacker violation called against Baylor. And so Hawaii gets the point, and like we saw in the previous two sets, Baylor early lead. Hawaii claws its way back into the picture, trailing now by just two. Jackson dug up by Akiu. Bump set Castillo by the double block right there is Philo. Here's Presley way up in the air, gets it down.
It's been a long time since Presley scored. Almost like she's hungry for more sets. Picks up kill number 13.
So Baylor back up by three. Burns in the middle. Sent it long. Was there a touch? No touch. Natasha thought there was. But it's a point for the Bears. And they are back up four. A challenge here from Matos. First challenge we have seen from the Rainbow Wahine, and they're going to challenge, I assume, the no-touch call at the net.
Exactly. Robin Amos Santos thought that Fanning might, right there, Fanning touching. See your finger bend back?
It was either Fanning or Vandermark, but yeah, that right looks there. Like a touch right there.
That's a touch.
And that looks pretty clear. You don't normally get a clear look at a touch via these replays.
Yeah, that was very rare.
But that is a great challenge by Amos Santos if Bill Forrester agrees.
Touch.
And there he does. And that gets Robin a little pumped up, making her second NCAA appearance in as many seasons as head coach. All the questions all year about whether this team was positioned in the RPI rankings, some early season losses that hurt their efforts. Got all the way up to 46, though, in the latest RPI ratings, and it was just good enough
amazing,
to get them in.
Amazing how they got off that bubble.
Fanning dug up back over the net by Ma'afala. Fanning a second time. Akiu couldn't conjure up the save.
You may be able to stop Fanning once, but you're not going to stop her twice. She's just too good a player.
So 12 serving 9. Brea Hunt retreats back. Ryan McGuire calls her a natural leader. She is from right there in Waco, Texas. Backside, Yosia blocked and roof. Got it turned back. Fanning and Presley all over that one by Yosia. And so we're seeing some minor adjustments made on some of these blocks. This one much more fully formed on the Baylor side of the net than we saw earlier in the match.
Exactly, and that set just a little bit too tight to the net.
Here's Castillo, they need it. Good up there by Hunt. Presley from off the net. Block out a piece, Yosia plays it off of the block. But a chance here for the Baylor Bears, and they go slide action to Shelly Fanning. And it's a 5-point advantage for the Bears.
Great set that time for Fanning. That time, lock and put it right where Fanning likes it.
Here's Yosia by the double block and wide. Tried to go line. It's a point for the Bears. And they have opened up a 6-point advantage. And Robin, I think, is going to challenge this call. She's going to challenge the in-out call.
Yeah. Also, as we've talked many times, another way to get a little timeout.
Sure.
And not use your second and final timeout.
Well, there was a timeout used by Hawaii earlier, and so even though Baylor got to 15, the media timeout gets wiped away. And so you're right, this is a chance for her to do a little bit more coaching and instruction while they take a look at this.
And if they win it, 14-10 is a lot more friendly score than 15-9, to be sure.
A 4-0 Baylor run pending this review. But we're definitely seeing a Hawaii team that is laboring much more here in this third set than what we saw in the first two frames. Why is that, you think?
Well, you know, two teams that are this evenly matched, it's rare you're going to see one team sweep the other. And the more likely thing at the end of the first two sets would have been a 1-1 split. You know, there are only 4 points apart those two for the first two sets. And so I'm not surprised at all that the third set might go to the team that lost the first two. And volleyball kind of works that way. The momentum swings back and forth, and it often goes to the team that just got beat twice in a row.
Not a lot of available angles there, I should say. And so Bill Forrester is going to keep the call as is. And from at least that high angle, which isn't necessarily conclusive, it looked like it was in. So that may be just a bit of bad luck on the part of Hawaii not having a better angle, because that sure had chances of being a Rainbow Wahine point. Good save there by Philo. Presley hammers it home. Well, Presley will get the numbers. That's 14 kills for her. Fanning is up into double figures as well. But Ania Philo has been a player that I think has contributed to the things turning around, the trends, the vibe of this match back in Baylor's direction.
No question.
Overpass. Pickens there for Fanning. And in a way,
right now. A lot of credit to Brea Hunt right now. She is pinpointing her serves to force Hawaii's Castillo or Skyler Williams to pass the ball instead of Hawaii's primary passers.
Hawaii trying to get out of this funk. It's Yosia missing wide. Point for Baylor. Did they call a touch on the block? Ryan McGuire pleading his case. Brea Hunt getting ready to serve, still has the volleyball, but I think they called a touch on the block.
I'm not sure which person called the touch.
Yeah, there's no such touch.
Maybe there was a net violation?
That's peculiar. I think it was just assumed by all parties that was another Baylor point. It was 18 serving 9.
Must have been a net violation.
Well, either way you slice it, it's a point for Hawaii. Flat-footed float serve there by Yosia. She goes outside. Castillo against a solo blocker. Trying to catch Hawaii napping. Great effort by Granato to extend the play. And then Fanning drops the hammer again.
You know, Kano, I think that one of the things that Ryan McGuire must have told his setters, got to feed Fanning more. You can't lean on Presley too much and be too predictable. But let's set the person who hits over 400 on the year, the number 12 kill percentage in the country.
That's now 12 kills for Fanning. She's hitting 478. Gaskin off the block. Williams got dug up. A little back and forth ping pong action. Now it's Philo by the block and down. And this is a completely different looking Baylor team that we are seeing in this third set. They lead by 9. Timeout, Hawaii. Welcome back. Well, Shelly Fanning had 6 kills after the first two sets. She has 6 kills in this third frame alone, C-Mac.
And she's got 5 blocks. She's hurting the bows everywhere. Great little step out move there. So she's hitting from the right side a lot, and she's obviously hitting in the middle, showing why she is an All-American.
This Baylor team showing a little bit more why it's so highly regarded.
And they're siding out at an 89% clip right now. If you side out at about 68, 70, that's pretty good. If you side out at 89, that's monster. Hawaii siding out right now at 47% and hitting 042 in this third set.
How about the change here made by Robin Amon Santos as Kamale Krug, the true freshman out of Anuenue, onto the floor. Crew playing in just her 17th set of the season. Philo dug up by a Q. That set off the net, so Granato couldn't get much behind it. Chance here for the Bears. They go slide to Fanning. And she delivers again. That's 13 kills for Shelly Fanning. Just taking over here in this middle set.
Bo's going to be breathing a sigh of relief. Fanning's going in the back row.
But it's Hawaii now having ball control issues on its side of the net. Philo through the block and down. She's heated up. She has 10 kills. That's now three players into double figures in kills for the Bears.
This isn't the same Baylor team we saw in the first two sets, is it?
Unrecognizable compared to that team. A 10-2 Bears run. Here's Granato. A much-needed Hawaii point.
Granato leading all Rainbow Wahine with 8 kills now. Utah Painter's got two players in double figures, Presley and Fanny with 14 and 12, respectively.
Away with 8 kills for Hawaii. Here's Gong with the serve. Burns got a swipe on that dump shot attempt, and then Granato got blocked up by Burns. Granato again going high hands. Presley the save. Save by Yosia. Gaskin lays out. And that one hit wide by Jalen Jackson. So Hawaii withstanding a long one and pulling out the win on that point. And they still trail 13 serving 21. Philo. Saved by Yosia. Here's Granato. Presley able to keep it alive. Philo from off the net. Gone on one knee with the save. Burns got under it. Sent it long.
Why unable to get the middle attack going right now. It's been a long time since either Burns or Sky Williams has put one down without a strong middle attack. Outside hitters are seeing two blockers all the time.
Hawaii hitting .034 here in the third compared to .353 for the Bears. I mean, they have just dominated in every facet. Gaskin goes long. And that's a point for the Bears. And you almost get the feeling like Hawaii's just ready to get out of this third set, start afresh in the fourth.
Yeah. Gaskin thought there was a touch there, but with the game this much out of hand here, Robert Mo Santos wasn't about to use up one of her challenge cards.
Granato, low set, and that was easy pickings on the block. As Marika Vandermark at 6'6 was up there next to Jalen Jackson. Putting up the wall, it is set point here for Baylor in the third. Gaskin from off the net, blocked back. Gaskin a second time off the block and out. The concern, though, is this performance by Baylor in the third enough to change the match? I'm not just talking about on the scoreboard, but in terms of the vibe, the feel, it seems like this is now a Baylor's team that once again believes in itself, not shaken at times like we saw in the first two frames.
Good point, Kunal, good point. I think Hawaii's also got to say to themselves, wow, we've got to regroup.
Jackson ends it in the third. And so the Bears, perhaps in hibernation the first two sets, they wake up in a big way in the third, and we got ourselves a match here in the NCAA tournament. Welcome back. Well, my, how things have changed. What a difference a single set can make. Hawaii up 25-23, 25-23, two sets to none in this match. And then they just get run over by the 25th-ranked Baylor Bears. And now they start anew in set four, but the Bears clearly with the momentum on their side.
Yeah, they outblocked Hawaii 3-1. They're out digging Hawaii 55-52. They hit them 371 to 0-0-0. Hawaii really struggling, only getting 8 kills to go along with 8 errors in that third set. So give all the credit to Baylor and their players and the staff for putting together an almost perfect third set.
Looking for a spark, Robinamo Santos turns to the spark plug. McKenna Ross, who time and time again throughout her career has come through in a situation like this, has at least provided some energy for this Rainbow Wahine team. Robinamo Santos obviously convinced they were pretty flat in that third set. There's no two ways about it. And so McKenna Ross, one of those players that can inject some life into the fray.
We'll see if she can do it here as Hawaii gets to start out by serving first.
McKenna Ross started 3 of the last 6 matches at outside hitter for Hawaii this season. Back in there to start set number 4. Hawaii up 2-1, first round of the NCAA tournament, and that set off the mark, and Presley forced into an out ball. You see the hitting errors on either side. For the match, Hawaii hitting .087. It's .192 on the side of the Bears. Faith Ma'afala, that one just clears the net. Here's Presley rising high, diving save Ross, but easy pickings there for Jackson as she pounds it back down.
Nice tap down by Jalen Jackson. You gotta be happy for Jalen. She's been through so many injuries her first 3 years, and to get to play this last half of the season healthy, she's just been one happy camper and playing her best volleyball ever.
Ross with the pass. One hand set by Ma'afala. Burns got blocked. Ma'afala this time goes right side to Granato, and the door is locked. That's Fanning and Presley. There were some holes, some cracks in that block earlier in this match. Not anymore.
Not now. You'll see it cannot find it. Those forehands across, solid. Those two All-Americans side by side.
So 2 serving 1, and the out serve there by Wolf.
The 12th service error by Baylor. Hawaii with only 6 service errors.
So here is McKenna Granato to serve. And that goes out. Now, there was an interesting little bit of entertainment that played out between sets 2 and 3, where you had McKenna's dad, Steve, and McKenna Ross's dad, Jason, former UH football and baseball player. They competed together against what were presumably maybe parents of Baylor players on the other side in a game where they had to do a reverse crab walk from one end of the floor to the other while balancing a volleyball in their lap. And as difficult as that was to explain, we're happy to say that the Hawaii parents won. See what Ross has done here this season. And we're going to have a reversal in the call.
Yeah, it was Ross definitely tooled the block. And the head referee just didn't get the call from Bill Forrester, the R2, until late.
That was pretty funny. You had 2 players, each with a volleyball at opposite service lines. Something had to give as Presley was able to avoid the Hawaii block. The fortuitous bounce off of the net and down. And so 4 serving 3 here, Bears. Opportunity presenting itself for Hawaii. They were given new life, receiving an at-large bid for the 2nd straight year into the NCAA tournament. Trying to take advantage of it here. They were up 2-0. Bears storming back, though, and an ace by Chanel Bramschreiber.
Tricky rotation for Hawaii right here, too. 2 small outsides in Yosia and Ross, and 1 big middle in Williams.
And the first ace of the match right there for Baylor. Here's Philo. Diving save a cue. That's dig number 22. Ross is blocked back. Ma'afala highballs it to McKenna Ross again. And a net violation against the Bears. Point Hawaii. What is it about players like McKenna Ross where they just seem ready no matter what time of the match, no matter where on the floor, they're just ready to go?
Well, she's also fearless. You know, when she goes up, she just swings for the fences sometime, or makes the really smart play like she did on the last tool job on the outside blocker.
Good save there by Yosia. Back bump set, a cue to Ross off the block and down. Point Hawaii.
The other thing McKenna brings, I think she brings, is a lot of diversity in the range of where she's going to hit the ball. See there, she goes off the outside blocker again. It's obviously she's not going to go cross court against the big middles.
You'll see it with the serve down the line. Philo, pass tight to the net. They go to Fanning. She's blocked. Williams dunks it down. Point for Hawaii, and they're back up one.
Hawaii seems to be playing with new life.
3-0 run here by the Rainbow Wahine. Down the line it goes. Philo, good pass. They go right side to Fanning. She sends it long. No touch up front. Point Hawaii, they're up two.
A rare error from the high, the number 12 kill percentage player in the country. And the best kill percentage player tonight.
Can Yosia keep the pressure on? She's been attacking Philo, who's been sticking those passes. She does so again. Another brilliant pass. She gets the set on the outside this time. Cross court and wide. No touch on the Hawaii side of the net. Point for the Rainbow Wahine. That is a 5-0 run being put together. This time it's Wolf with the pass. Fanning off the block and down. Past the diving gasket. And so Baylor able to apply that tourniquet, and it is Fanning retreating back to serve.
Again, you may stop Fanning once, but you aren't going to stop her twice in a row. Hawaii's gotten about half of their points now on hitting errors by Baylor in this set.
Ross just tried to touch it past the block. Fanning may have gotten away with the miss hit, but it is Presley sending it long anyway, so a point for the Rainbow Wahine.
Hawaii definitely the beneficiary of some Baylor self-inflicted wounds, whether it be balls that are hit out or ball handling errors.
So nine serving six. Baylor hitting negative 0-9-1 so far in the fourth. Here's Philo. Good dig by Acue. Bump set by Williams, and Granato just touches it over. Philo again from off the net, dug up by Yosia. Here's Okino with the bump set to Gaskin. And she lights it up.
Where did that come from? And how about the bump set from Rika Okino forces Baylor to call timeout?
In her first NCAA tournament match, Angel Gaskin delivering. Well, maybe this is where McKenna Ross gets it. On the right there, doing that reverse crab walk, balancing the volleyball, is Jason Ross, her pops. That was between sets two and three. They had Jason and McKenna Granato's dad, Steve, pairing up. And it was the Hawaii guys beating the two Baylor representatives in that heated matchup between sets two and three. And that put down by Philo for Baylor out of the timeout. Hawaii was enjoying its largest lead of this fourth set.
Philo, nice tip shot. She's mixing her shots up quite well. That time of hitting the ground there before Yosia could get there. Philo now with 11 kills. She's come way back from a slow start tonight.
How about 23 digs for Tita Acue, by the way? On the Hawaii side, overpass. Yosia somehow touched it back over. Here's Philo, blocked and roofed. Noreen Yosia was a back row player, did not leave her feet, and was able to still somehow apply resistance at the net.
Exactly, that was a very rare play. When centers are up there like that, and from there coming from the back row, very often they'll get hit right in the face of the team chooses to just tap it straight down. Instead, Noreen protected herself and kept the rally alive.
That block has reawakened a bit here for Hawaii, but they're going to catch Granato for reaching over. A little too aggressive that time. Point for the Bears. And it is Philo back behind the line to serve. Here's Gaskin. Oh, that's set outside the pin. Gaskin had to work just to keep it in. The dig there by Okino. Outside set, Granato. Roll shot. Diving save. Presley, well done. She'll get the swing. Dug up by Aku. Number 24 for her. Here's Granato. Through the block and down. And McKenna Granato gets the double figures and kills.
And finally, Hawaii's starting to dig some of Presley's shots coming out of the back row. And Granato, nice swing against the split block.
24 digs now for a cue. That's two off of her Hawaii career high.
Ryan McGuire right now is questioning whether or not McKenna Granato's shot.
I think it was actually Angel Gaskin.
Angel Gaskin's shot went outside the antenna.
Because the line judge down that antenna line was waving the flag, signaling that it hit the pin.
Yeah, what really happened was Angel run into the pole.
Yeah.
And it had shaken the pole. Watch it here. I think she keeps this in play, but it looks like the antenna's hit because the antenna shakes right there. Good call by the officials.
Yeah, Jason Olson, the R1, is right there as the serve goes down the line and wide.
That was an important scoring opportunity for Hawaii. It's Ma'afala, arguably Hawaii's most productive server. That time she gave one up there.
Initially claimed that one of the Baylor players touched it on the way out, but they decided not to challenge. It's 9 serving 12. That one tickles the tape. Burns in the middle. Not a lot of thrust behind it. Vandermark dug up by Aku. That's 25 for her. Burns! One hand diving save beautifully done by Flegel. Hawaii now on the attack. It's Okino. Back bump set. Yosia off the block and out. Point for Hawaii.
5'10 Yosia going up against the 6'6 Erika Vandermark from the Netherlands. Big block on the outside. You'll see it, not afraid.
8 kills, 9 assists, 11 digs for Noreen Yosia. She is closing in on a possible 5th triple-double this season. Fanning, just doing Shelly Fanning things.
What Fanning does, yeah. If she sees the block take her cross court, she cuts back across her body. She sees him take her cut back, she'll go away. Wrist away, but boy, she's some kind of player.
Baylor flatlining it though here in this fourth set. Ma'afala goes backside. Yosia tried to go over the double block, maybe got a little too precise with it.
Yeah, that set a little bit wide too, and I think Noreen got caught underneath it a little too much. She got a little eager coming in too early in her approach.
So 11 serving 13, Baylor applying a little bit of pressure here. Burns in the middle.
First connection with Burns, I think, has been clean since the first set.
Yeah, Hawaii with some early success feeding the middles. That was a powerful blow that time by Natasha Burns. Presley from off the net, right there is Granato. Ma'afala goes middle to Williams. Dug up by Wolf. That was beautiful. Slide goes to Fanning. Williams got a touch. Here's Ross on the second swing. She'll get it again. Baylor on the attack. Fanning in the middle. Right there is a cue. Bump set Ma'afala. And nothing that Yosia could do with it. She tried to see if she could just get a piece of that block. But there was nowhere to go. And it's a 2-point contest here in the fourth.
Tough rotation right here now. Brea Hunt has been really effective for that short serve, bringing Hawaii's front row attackers having to pass the ball. Not that time though.
Williams. Granato may have played an out ball. Here's Ross against the double block. A lot of contact there. Philo through the block and down. Point for the Bears.
The Bears regaining some momentum here. Good swing by Philo across court. Just powers it through the block.
And Robin Amo Santos is signaling for a timeout. We'll take a break as well. Well, Tita Aku in her very first NCAA tournament match puts up a Hawaii career high 26 digs to this point. She has just been all over the place.
And she's been passing the ball well on serve receive. She's just everywhere. She's an All-American in my opinion. She's one great libero.
Yeah, really the saddest part of Tita Aku's story with Hawaii is that it's only going to last one season. After transferring over from Texas Tech, McKenna Ross got it down.
McKenna Ross got a little adrenaline going, huh?
Four kills for Ross. No errors on nine swings. She did a little bit of this last year, if you remember, against Illinois in the opening round of the NCAA tournament in Seattle. Hawaii, two sets to none. Ross came in, helped spark them. It would go to five. Oh, Williams lost the joust. It was Hannah Locken getting the better of that matchup.
Locken, nice push there at the net. Did a nice job of staying out of the net as well.
So 14 serving 15. Here's Gaskin. Got it in the deep corner.
She's uncanny how she finds that corner.
Angel Gaskin, the second left-handed hitter in the history of this program. She's putting together quite the volleyball match. Seven kills, four blocks. Rico Aquino with the serve. Philo punches it long. And Hawaii up three.
A rare error from Philo. She's been almost perfect in the third set and this fourth set. That one. Kind of an anomaly. She also leads them in digs to this Philo, 17.
Here is Philo, time the jump, blocked back. So Wolf with the bump set to Philo. Dug up by Yosia, here's a cue. Bump set to Granato. Wolf able to get it up. Saved by a cue again, here's Granato. What a save by Philo. That was a heater, but the roof. One on one. Williams returns it to sender against Yossiana Presley.
Sky, how about this dig by Philo? Terrific dig. One of Granato's hardest hits of the night. And then Williams gets the last word on the All-American Presley. Great reach, nice footwork that time. Angelica Unquist has got to be tickled.
Well, if you rewind back, Sky Williams made quite the splash initially in her Hawaii career. Last year, as a true freshman in her debut match against Marquette, she posted a freshman record 12 blocks. And here she is. You fast forward to the end, or at least the postseason of the 2018 year, and she's got seven blocks here in this NCAA tournament match.
And she hasn't even been starting recently.
That's the thing.
Isn't that crazy?
But she's been showing signs, and Robin Amo Santos has been very vocal about what she thinks that player, Skylar Williams, can ultimately develop into.
Yeah, she's very optimistic about her upside potential, to be sure. And by the way, Sarah Leva, this is no knock against Sarah Leva, because Sarah Leva has played so well for Hawaii. But the matchups tonight, I think Robin felt like the matchup, Skylar Williams would match up better against this Baylor team than Sarah.
So Hawaii by four. Again, opening round of the NCAA tournament. There is Sarah Leva. We have yet to see her in this match. If Hawaii is to advance, they would play the winner of Oregon, New Mexico State. A couple of teams that the Hawaii program is familiar with. They went up against Oregon in Honolulu for a couple of matches. The Ducks were ranked 12th then. That was September 13th and 14th. Got swept and then lost in five. And there's a look at the Oregon squad.
In the second match in five, Hawaii had their chances to win that one and just got away from them.
So they're getting ready to take the court. And then you got New Mexico State head coach Mike Jordan. We used to see them pretty frequently in the old Western Athletic Conference days. As Okina serves it long out of the timeout. So here is Hannah Flegel. Aquino pops it straight up. Back bump set of cue to Granato. Philo with her 19th dig of the match. Here's Gaskin, two blockers up. And she goes wide. A point for Baylor, they're within two.
This is going to be the hardest 7 points Hawaii will ever earn, oh, trust me. From 18 to 25 is going to be tough.
You'll see it. To Granato, the dink, sniffed out by Flegel. Bump set goes to Philo. Block got a good piece. So you'll see it with options, goes out to Granato. Backside, it's Gaskin. Scores it for Hawaii.
Tough rotation for Hawaii, but Gaskin comes through big time. Gets a great set from Yosia.
Seven kills for Angel Gaskin, hitting a buck 30. Outside, this is Milana. And so Milana and Gaskin, the two former teammates at Maryland,
eyeball.
One another through the net right there.
Hawaii did their job at the net. They got a piece of the block, slowed the ball down. Back row did not get to it.
Passed by Aku. Outside. Granato, the dink. She's blocked. Punches it over but misses the court wide. And a point for the Bears. They're within one. 4-1 burst here by Baylor. It's now 45 attempts for Granato on the outside. You'll see it goes middle to Burns. Here's Milana. Played by Gaskin, so you'll see it. Goes backside to Angel. Bears on the attack. Here's Presley. The dink, diving save, you'll see it. Aquino bump set. Gaskin with two blockers up, hits it into the twine. Point for the Bears, and they have come back to knock things up at 19.
Robin Amos Santos is going to wait to call her second time out.
This fourth set is up for grabs. Granato blocked. Gaskin will get a swing out of it. Through the block and down! An unlikely put down by Angel Gaskin.
Smart play by Gaskin to take a little bit off that. She had no approach. It's a standing jump. It gets bumped up quickly. See, she had no approach at all. So all she had to do was just a step close and jump up and just keep the ball in play. And got Hawaii a point. Smart.
So Ma'afala, you mentioned it.
She'll go right down the line of Presley, I think.
She has been a consistent server, especially in the back half of the season. Philo from the back row dug up by Ma'afala. So Aquino, back bump set to Granato. Diving save, Philo. Here's Presley, blocked and roofed. Burns and Yosia.
The Akamai roofing block right there, the Manoa Roofing Company. Huge block at a crucial time in the game, but still tough points coming up.
21 serving 19. Hawaii 4 points away from advancing. Milana.
Gia Milana, who led Maryland in kills last year, comes up with a huge kill right there. Good swing.
Yeah, she just drove it through that block. All Big Ten. Honorable mention back in 2016. Good pass there by Aquino. Here's Granato. Can't find the floor. Presley, diving save Aquino. Ma'afala. Oh, that set way outside. And that's a point for Baylor. And we're tied again at 21 all. So you're seeing as many plays made on the Baylor side that have sort of bailed out Hawaii as you're seeing the other way.
Exactly.
Two-hand pass, Aquino. Burns in the middle, block got a good chunk of that. Fanning is dug up by Ma'afala. Aquino, bump set to Granato. tried to get cute with it, going cross court into the net. It goes, point for the Bears, and they vault in front. 22-21.
So the Bears are getting a lot of touches on Hawaii's swings at the net. Hawaii's struggling to win those transition battles.
Yeah, you're starting to see that in the psychology of Hawaii on the attack. They've started to, instead of rearing back and full swinging, you're starting to see them try to get precise around the block, and that doesn't often necessarily lead to good things.
Exactly. We call it avoidance attacking, and it's really hurt Hawaii the last 5 or 6 points for sure. But give Baylor a lot of credit. They're forcing Hawaii into making those decisions by putting up a really solid block and playing some great back row defense.
You got to appreciate the attitude of this Baylor squad. They were down 2-0. Things were not going very well. But as you pointed out, they lost both of those first two sets by merely 2 points. And considering how poorly and ineffective they had been in stretches throughout those first two frames, that unto itself could have been encouraging, saying, hey, look, we're playing about as bad as we can.
Yeah.
We're still almost pulling these out.
Exactly, exactly. How about the defense of Philo? 20 digs so far. Tita Q, 27 digs.
It's a career high.
Those two are putting on a clinic.
But it is now Baylor with the advantage, trying to push it to a fifth set here in this opening round NCAA tournament match. Okino the pass. Outside, it's Yosiya blocked back. Yosiya a second time blocked back. This time it's Granato on the other side, dug up by Wolf. Milano with the swing, blocked back. And Roof.
Ooh, Hawaii barely got out of that rally. Baylor again solid at the net and then getting good touches in the back row. Good swing by Milano. But a better Hawaii block.
So we are tied for the sixth time here in set four. It is anybody's set, meaning it is anybody's match. Milano off the high hands, chased down by Aku. Yosiya by the double block. Presley will get a full swing at it. Off the block and down. Kill number 16 for Yasiana Presley.
Two different offenses. Baylor with three players in double digits. Fanning, Presley, and Philo. Hawaii with no players in double figures. How about that?
Hawaii hitting 079 for the match.
Normally they hit around 240.
Yosiya with the pass. Outside, it's Ross. Blocked, kept alive by Yosiya, who gets the set on the right side. She's blocked. Played off the net by Burns. Fanning the swing, up by Ma'afala. Hawaii staying alive here. And Aku sends a free ball the way of the Bears. Fanning, the touch, punched up by Burns. Yosiya will just slap it over. The advantage still belongs to Baylor. Presley off the block. Hawaii somehow keeping all of these alive. Ross by the block and down. What a kill.
How does she do it? 5'10", facing a huge block. There's her dad, proud dad, Jason. Long rally, Hawaii patient. Ross sees the line open and buries it.
That was pure grit on the side of the Rainbow Wahine, just to stay alive in that one. Ryan McGuire is holding the challenge card and is having another one of those lengthy conversations with Bill Forrester.
It's his last usage of a challenge card, unless it goes to five.
That's right. Each side will get an extra challenge if it goes to a fifth. And so we are getting a challenge from Ryan McGuire on a possible net violation. So
he's also out of timeouts, by the way, as is Hawaii. Again, this sometimes is a good usage of a challenge to use it as a timeout, because you're allowed to talk to your players.
That was also a really long sequence, so it may have taken a little doing to explain to Bill Forster what part of that long play and rally exactly. he wants to look at. If you had said prior to the match, though, that Hawaii would be 2 points away from advancing in the fourth set while hitting 0-83 against the Baylor Bears, what would your reaction have been?
Ooh, I would say probably 3-0 Bears. Anytime you hit 0-83, that's not a good number. That's, you know, almost 200 points below your season average. It means the offense is really struggling. The other team is playing great defense. Again, whenever you see an outside hitter like Philo get 20 digs, more than the libero, Wolf, who's also played well, and she's got only 14, it really shows that, Baylor Bears are playing some great defense. They also got 10 blocks to go along with that. Hawaii, 11 blocks. Led, of course, by Sky Williams, 7.
You got 155 blocks between these two teams. Digs, I should say, between these two teams. So they are playing some defense for sure. Here's Ross as the call stood, as you saw, gets blocked and roofed. So Baylor gets to 24, and they will serve for the set. And a chance to push this to a decisive fifth. Presley with the serve. Maafala bump set to Yosia. Through the block, kept alive by Presley. Advantage Bears. Back row Presley, dug up by Granato. Maafala to Yosia. Got a piece. Got the point. We're tied at 24.
Baylor with the advantage most of that rally. Until Yosia bombs this one off the high hands.
That took some guts on that swing by Noreen, and she is now back behind the line to serve. Wolf with a perfect pass. Backside, and it's Fanning.
Oh, she loves going to Fanning on that right side. Fanning's so versatile.
Old faithful strikes again, Shelly Fanning. Hitting 389. Set point here for the Bears. You'll see a backside to Gaskin, blocked and roofed. Point for the Bears, and we will play a fifth set here in Eugene, Oregon. The Bears did not give up, down 0-2, and we will play a dramatic fifth set. Well, wouldn't you know it, we're headed to a fifth here in Eugene, Oregon at the Matthew Knight Arena on the campus of the University of Oregon. First round action from the NCAA tournament, the Rainbow Wahine. We're up 2-0. Thinking sweep. But the Baylor Bears, they had something else in mind. And after a win in set 3, a demonstrative one at that, 25-14, they pull it out in extras in the fourth, 26-24. And so we commented about the opportunity that was presented to Hawaii. Just get the field. And then the opportunity presented by virtue of winning the first two sets. But much of that opportunity has now been lost, and they are relegated to having to beat the 25th ranked team in the country in a race to 15.
Yeah, this is going to be interesting. You know, set 5 is, no coach wants to go to set 5 because there's so much luck involved. One misplay here or there can decide that set. And there's just so much strategy involved in what rotation you start out in. Are you going to change your rotation so that you can have a better matchup against the other team? Do you want your best server serving first or not? Do you want to have a good matchup on the other team's best player? How early do you call the first time out? There's just so much going on in the fifth set. And again, so much of it, there's just a lot of luck involved in winning the race to 15.
So Hawaii, this isn't going to be their first rodeo, so to speak, in a five-set match.
See, Ross is starting again here in the fifth set.
Hawaii 3-3 in five setters on the season. Baylor, if you're wondering, 4-2 in five set matches. So both teams have experienced woeful disappointment while also experiencing the joy of winning in five. The last time Hawaii was able to do so was that classic win over Cal Poly at the Stan Sheriff Center back on October 26th.
They need to channel those thoughts for the Cal Poly game, for sure.
So everything, in essence, gets thrown out the window, right? All of the statistics, everything that has brought us to this point, we set aside because it is about who gets to 15 first. And it will be Hawaii serving first. Faith Ma'afala back behind the line. Winner of this fifth set moves on in the NCAA tournament. Middle set goes to Jackson, dug up by Aku. That is dig number 30 for Tita Aku. And for Natasha Burns, that's kill number 7. And Hawaii off the schneid first.
How did Aku get in the way of that ball? She's uncanny in her positioning in the back row. Amazing.
30 digs for Tita. Ma'afala with the ace.
You know, she nearly had an ace on the first, in her first serve. Her ball was dying fast, but Wolf brought it up. That time she went right for Presley, and it just moves all over the place. Presley had to get out of the way.
Yeah, you had Wolf squeezing Presley over there on that sideline. See if Ma'afala tries to play with that again. This time goes right at Wolf. Backside set. Milana is dug up. Here's Granato. Good swing, but she sends it long. Was there a touch? No touch.
Aku with yet another dig to keep that rally alive. Granato going for the high hands and just missed.
9 kills on 51 swings for Mack. Good pass there by Ross. Backside, it's Granato through the block. Saved by Philo. Here's Presley. Pitter-pattered around on the Hawaii side of the net, but Ross's bump just doesn't exceed the top of the twine. And so it's a point for Baylor, and we're tied at 2.
It's a game of inches. Here's the ball kept off the ground by about 6 inches, and misses by 2 inches from going over the net.
Here's Yosia on the outside. Down the line, missed it wide. Point for Baylor. So they jump up 3-2. So many twists and turns in this match. Tara Wolf, the walk-on, who won the libero position this season with another serve and another roof. Courtesy Presley right up there next to her teammate Shelly Fanning.
Yeah, that's a tough block. Presley and Fanning have proved to be tough all night long. See him pressing over the net there, tough to penetrate that big a block.
13th team block for the Bears, 4 serving 2. That one played by Ross, straddling the line. Here's Yosia dug up by Wolf. What a dig. Milana just has to dink it over. Chance here for Hawaii outside. It's Yosia through the block and down.
Triple double for Yosia.
Right. First player into double figures in the kill category for Hawaii.
Amazing. You know, 5 sets and only have 1 player in double figures. That means that Ma'afala and Yosia are really distributing the ball to everybody.
But how about that line for Noreen? Her 5th triple double of the season. And an ace. Dealt out of the deck there by Mack. And we're tied at 4.
Boy, looking down, being down 4-2. Next thing you know, it's 4 off.
Well, this team has been through it all, right? They have traversed the valleys and the peaks.
Another tough serve.
Milana from off the net, into the twine it goes. Point for Hawaii.
Granato, 3 straight tough serves in a row.
It's imperative to get those serves in a fifth set. Can she do it again? These two teams played to 5 sets last year, if you remember, in Honolulu. Hawaii won in 5. The dig by Aku. Burns tried to touch it over. Here's Presley into the pin. Point Hawaii.
Ooh, Hawaii gets a break from Baylor's most prolific attacker.
Six serving four. And a timeout taken by Ryan McGuire. We'll take a break as well. Fifth set drama in Eugene. Welcome back to Eugene, Oregon. We're amid the fifth set here. Hawaii up 6-4. And we'd love to say that this fifth set has been a duel of powerful, effective offenses. It hasn't been the case.
Yeah, Hawaii hitting negative two kills, three errors. Baylor hitting negative one kill, two errors. Go figure.
Seven of the first 10 points in this fifth set have come by way of errors. Presley dug up by a Q. That's dig number 33 for Tita. And the block is tooled by McKenna Ross. She has six kills.
She loves to tool that outside blocker, doesn't she? She'll miss once in a while by getting a little bit greedy, but most of the time, she'll catch a hand on the outside.
Hawaii has scored five straight. They lead seven serving four. Mack gets the serve in again, and they're out of system on the Bears side. Philo the dink. Chance for Hawaii. Ma'afala goes to Yosia. Does she get a touch? No touch. Misses the court wide. It's a point for the Bears.
Not sure about that setting decision there. I thought she might go to Burns in the middle or Ross on the outside. Yosia had just dug the ball. I'm not sure she was really ready for it.
So it's Brea Hunt now to serve. Burns retrieves it, and it's an overpass pounded home by Fanning. And Robin Amo Santos
telling Burns, it's not your ball. Let the back row people handle it. So Brea Hunt's been so effective serving that short serve like that one right there.
You'll see the dink. It finds the floor. That was a similar situation that we saw moments ago. You'll see with the pass. Ma'afala went right back to her. That time it worked. They will swap ends. And Hawaii takes an 8-6 advantage in the fifth into the breather.
No safe lead, 8-6 in the fifth. Not something really very comfortable, would you say, Kanoa?
That's been proven otherwise here so far in this match, and Robin's expression says it all.
Is her hair turning gray, or is it just me? Oh, maybe it's the monitor we have here.
So they swap ends, a cue with the serve, and the pounding hit by Shelly Fanning gets Baylor the point. Seven serving eight coming up. I mean, you look at the numbers on Baylor's side versus Hawaii, and you have three players in double figures. Fanning now leading the way with 18, hitting 410. Just one player in double figures and kills for Hawaii. That's an arena you'll see. In a five-set match, here's Ross. Finds the floor, but goes wide of the antenna. It actually landed in, but went outside the pin. And so that's a point for the Bears. And guess what? We're tied at eight.
The lead just evaporated.
And that's an ace. Graham Schreiber with the ace for Baylor. And they're up 9-8 in the fifth. Desperation time for Hawaii. Welcome back. Well, this entire season, all of those practices, all of those laps around the track, all of those ups and downs of an 18-8 record for the Rainbow Wahine, it comes down to this. Either they move on or the season is pow. And out of the timeout, the out serve by Chanel Graham Schreiber allows Hawaii to tie things up at nine. Hawaii won the first two sets, and then Baylor came storming back. And so here we are. It's now a race to six to see who moves on in the NCAA tournament. Set goes right side. It's Fanning. One hand diving save by a Q. Ross sets up Gaskin. She gets blocked and roofed. Was too tight to the net for Gaskin to do much with it. And she was smothered by Fanning.
Finally, somebody dug Fanning, though. Q stuck her arm out there, at least kept the ball alive. Hawaii stayed in the rally, but again, a good block by Baylor at the net.
10 serving 9. Fanning with the serve. Hawaii needs a point. Bump set goes to Ross. And that lands in off the block. Point for Baylor. They get another roof. That's number 15 for the Bears as Jackson got the gist of it. The Hawaii contingent on hand trying to make some noise. Williams. Good set there from Yosia. And Hawaii back within a digit.
Finally, a little bit of offense by Hawaii. They're now hitting 0-0-0, I think, for this fifth set. Maybe when they're hitting 0-83.
Here is Okino with the serve. Goes right at Wolf. She handles it easily. Philo on the outside blasts it off the block. No, it did not touch the block. It misses wide. The call, at least, is that it is wide, and it's a point for Hawaii. And Ryan McGuire immediately grabbing the challenge card.
Because he's got one more challenge in the fifth set.
I think that may have gotten a piece of gasket.
I don't know. It looked like a mister. Did you see a touch there?
Well, the challenge apparently is not on the touch. The challenge is on the in-out call.
Oh, wow. I don't think that was close. No, not even close. It's way out.
I actually thought there may be more of a case on the part of Ryan McGuire
for the touch.
To challenge the touch.
Yeah.
Busy evening here for Bill Forrester.
Yeah.
And this is a big call.
Yeah, big difference between 12-10 and 11-0.
Again, the winner of this match takes on the winner of Oregon and New Mexico State. If you're one of those head coaches, you're kind of loving the fact that these two teams are going at each other like this.
Absolutely.
There's a look at Mike Jordan.
Yep, you're loving that these two teams are spending themselves on a back-to-back situation. Most of the teams in this league and all the leagues around the country split up their matches. One midweek match and one weekend match. I'd call that ball out. That's pretty definitive. That ball's out.
You know, it'll be interesting if the Bears move on. Then it would be a particular challenge for Shelly Fanning. Right, they have limited the amount of jumps that she has per day, per workout, because she's dealing with that lower leg stress fracture, playing through it, sticking it out, starting all matches this season. But in the Big 12, they don't play on back-to-back nights like what Hawaii experiences in the Big West Conference. They usually go Wednesday, Saturday. And so the back-to-back dynamic, if Baylor does advance, that's going to be a challenge for this team, especially coming off of a five-setter.
Absolutely.
So Hawaii maintains the point, 11-all. Here's Philo off the block and out, no doubt that time. Philo's been really good. 13 kills now for her, 21 digs. She also has four blocks.
Once again, the two Maryland transfers are going eyeball to eyeball, Gaskin and Milana.
Here's Flegel with the serve. Hawaii trailing by one. Granato off the block and out. Point Hawaii. We're tied at 12. They are trading blows in the middle of the ring here in set five. And you start to get into that thought process of it's going to be a shame that one of these teams has to call it a season after what they have laid out here on the floor at the Matthew Knight Arena. Milana from off the net. Advantage Hawaii. Can they cash it in? Gaskin off the block, kept alive there by Wolf. Milana, second time, blocked back. Punched up by Jackson. Free chance here for Hawaii. Yosia goes outside. Granato off the block. Philo swings at it out of the air and hits it down.
What an athletic play by Philo there. Blocks high. Look at this. Really smart to go up right away and pound it down. What a great play.
just bounced right back up off the deck. And it is 13 serving 12. Huge swing. Hawaii had the advantage on that sequence. Here's Granato. Got it inside that end line. Well, it has not been the most efficient of matches for McKenna Granato, but there is no doubt that Noreen Yosiya, Faith Maafala, they know Mac is the go-to hitter for this squad, and they have continued to look to the senior, and that time she delivered. Maafala with the serve, tied at 13. Milana hits it long. Was there a touch? No touch. Point for Hawaii. It is Aloha Bowl for the match. And a timeout taken by the Baylor Bears.
That was all started by Faith Maafala's great serve that put Baylor out of system with the pass to the 15-foot line. Milana didn't have much to work with, but boy, she sure took a big swing.
Give us an idea of what some of the discussion is on either side here in this all-important huddle, you think?
Well, I'll tell you what's going on in Hawaii's huddle. The first thing is Faith Maafala serve in, because I think that they've got Baylor in a favorable rotation here. And I think for Baylor, I think they're saying, where is Presley right now? Let's find her. She's on the left. I think the set's going to go to Presley no matter what. So we'll see if Ryan McGuire is giving those instructions. But they've got to get a good pass up to also have a hopefully a middle presence. Not sure if who's up front right now. Or Jalen Jackson's up front. So, you know, with all due respect to Jackson, I don't think she's going to get the set here in a crucial situation. I think it's going to go outside to Presley.
Well, there were some who thought that Hawaii would not even get this opportunity. And here they are looking at Aloha Bowl to advance in the NCAA tournament.
Against the 25th ranked team in the country.
Maybe the most important serve of Faith Maafala's career. The Hawaii fans who made the journey, they're on their feet. It gets over. Wolf with a good pass. Right side, Milana. Hammers it home.
That is a gutsy set, I'm telling you. Milana just hit the last ball out. And Fliegel goes right back to her, fooling Hawaii's block. Only one blocker up.
I mean, that was just cool on the part of Baylor. No panic whatsoever in the Bears right there. Here's Yosiya, blocked back, covered by Okino. Bump set tight to the net. Yosiya is blocked and roofed. Milana had her hand in on that one as well, next to Shelly Fanning, and it is Baylor facing match point. And a timeout taken by the Rainbow Wahine.
I guess it's only fitting that this should be a momentum shift again. Look at Robin Amos Santos giving some smiles there, getting the girls to relax a little bit. I'll tell you, Yosiya did everything she could to tool Milana's right hand. Probably took the right shot right there, but Milana had just too much pressing in toward the court there.
And how about Gia Milana? You mentioned the ball that put Hawaii in an advantageous position. She comes through with the calm, cool, and collected swing to tie things up, and then comes up with the stuff to give Baylor match point.
Yep, the Maryland transfer is having maybe her biggest night of the year.
Wearing number 77 on her jersey. You don't see that combo too frequently. She wanted number 7 for personal reasons. 7 wasn't available. Hannah Fliegel wearing that one. And so she thought, well, what's one better than 7? How about 2 7s?
Yeah. Once again, the offenses in this fifth set have not been sterling. Hawaii, 7 kills, 8 errors, hitting negative. Baylor, not much better, 6 kills, 4 errors, hitting 100. Side out percentage for both teams, also meager. 42% for Hawaii and 46% for Baylor. It's been a defensive battle.
And so it comes down to this. Hawaii backs against the wall. They go from serving for match point to now receiving the serve on match point for Baylor. Aloha ball for the Bears. And it's Tara Wolf, the float serve. Mafala goes backside. Granato kept alive by a Q off the block. Free chance here for Baylor. They go right side. Milana down in, and that is your volleyball match. The Baylor Bears come from behind down 0-2 to advance in the NCAA tournament and end the Rainbow Wahine in their 2018 season. What a turnaround, what a match, and what a finish. But it is Baylor moving on. Ryan McGuire, whose team was reeling after the first two sets, had lost in five to Hawaii last year, but this time when it mattered the most in the postseason, he was able to get his squad to gut out a victory. Next up will be the winner of Oregon and New Mexico State. 18 kills for Shelly Fanning to lead the way for the Bears. 17 kills for Yasiana Presley. And how about Ania Filo? 14 kills and 21 digs. But Gia Milana, as mentioned, the Maryland transfer, came up with 2 kills and a block for those final 3 Baylor points. Really when it mattered the most. On the other side for Hawaii, 34 digs, a career high for Tita Aku. 11 kills apiece for McKenna Granato and Noreen Yosia. So while we're on the topic of statistics, Bank of Hawaii presents the players of the match. Tita Aku with those 34 digs gets the nod for Hawaii. 3 assists and a kill. Shelly Fanning was just great. 18 put downs, hitting 410 blocks on the evening as Baylor would go on to outblock Hawaii 16-12. So the Rainbow Wahine see the 2018 season come to an end. They finished the year 18-9 overall, but put up a fight worth recognition and worth acknowledgement in the opening round of the NCAA tournament. They received the opportunity they didn't think they would have. Then they faced the golden opportunity of being up 2-0. Ultimately, though, that opportunity would be lost at the hands of the Baylor Bears. Chris McLaughlin is with Robin Amos-Santos. Chris.
Coach, it seems like neither team should lose that match. Both played so hard all night long. What are your thoughts overall on how your team played?
I mean, I think they came out, we wanted to start off good. They came out, started out good for those, you know, first two sets and came out flat the next two, but I'm proud of them. They fought back this, you know, in the fifth set. I'm proud of them.
Such a marvelous year going toe-to-toe against the number 25 team in the country, a winnable match. You do have to be so proud. How about Tita Aku tonight? 34 digs.
34, that's her vacuum cleaner. I mean, what can I say? She does that. She helps us out with our passing. You know, that's what the reason why we get two-man passing. She's awesome.
Coach, great year. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Sorry you lost.
It's okay.
Back to you, Kanoa.
Thanks a lot, C-Mac. Yeah, there's no other way that Robin Amos-Santos can feel about this team but proud with the effort that they left out there on the floor. It was not to be, however. And so Hawaii's season is pow. Baylor advances. All right, don't forget about the Heineken postgame show. C-Mac and I will have a little bit more to discuss here on this season-ending match in the NCAA tournament. Hawaii, for the second straight year, falls in the opening round of the dance in a grueling five-setter. Last year it was Illinois. This year, it's the Baylor Bears. More after this. Well, a career effort from Tita Aku. She was digging up everything this entire match, had a career high 34 digs. Just a special performance from Tita, C-Mac.
Yeah, Robin Amos-Santos just called her. She is the vacuum cleaner, and tonight she was at her best. It was really fun to watch her play volleyball tonight. She's amazing.
Meanwhile, Noreen Yosia, 5th triple-double recorded this season. She went for 11 kills, 14 assists and 15 digs. Hawaii took the first two sets, 25-23 each, but then Baylor turned it around, and a lot of that was credited to Yasiana Presley. 17 kills, only hit 0-8-8, but she also had 9 digs and 6 blocks. And then Shelly Fanning, Old Faithful, 18 kills, a match high. She hit 400, and it was a double-double effort, 10 blocks.
Yeah, Baylor block, I thought, made the biggest difference the last three sets. Sets 3, 4, and 5, they were just big at the net. And if Hawaii had any tight sets at all, they were in trouble because that Baylor block would just shove it right back down on Hawaii's side of the court.
There you see the final arithmetic. Hawaii taking the first two sets, but then it was 25-14, 26-24, and 16-14 Bears to take it in 5. Post-game showtime.
From Spectrum Sports, it's the Heineken Post-Game Show.
All right, yeah, here courtside at Matthew Knight Arena on the campus of the University of Oregon. So this is how the season ends for the second consecutive year, C-Mac. Hawaii losing in 5 in the opening round of the NCAA tournament. You could just feel the melancholy in the voice of Robin Amos Santos. Tough way to go out.
Yeah, really tough. That team works so hard all year long, and then it comes so close, and yet so far, Robin, such a competitor, she did not want to lose tonight. So you could tell how hurt she was, but she's also really proud of her team, you could tell that. And this team, so courageous the way they played against, very often against much bigger teams. Tonight, Baylor was a large team, played big at the net, made it really tough. Hitters, who I hit probably for one of their lowest percentages of the year on offense.
All right, before we get big picture oriented, let's take a look at the final match statistics. Hawaii, just to be in that match was astounding when you consider their hitting percentage, 0-6-3 for the match.
Unbelievable. And you see how they got outblocked, 16-12. It was just really, really difficult for the offense to get going. And Robin Amos Santos did everything she could to change things up. I thought that Faith Maafala and Noreen Yosia set a good volleyball game. A lot of distribution went around to everybody. It was almost like they were trying to find somebody who could get past that Baylor block, and it wasn't always successful.
So it is Baylor advancing. They will get ready for a matchup with the winner of Oregon and New Mexico State here in this sub-regional pod. Those two teams taking the floor as we speak, and certainly I would imagine both coaches watching that, assuming that they're going to advance out of this upcoming match, happy that Hawaii and Baylor pushed each other so feverishly in the match, because it sets up for a pretty tough turnaround for the Bears tomorrow.
Oh, you always love to play a tired team, no question about that. Who doesn't?
That's right.
But, and what a great venue that Hawaii got to play in. The Matthew Knight Arena has been tremendous. Girls so excited to be here. And you're happy for the three seniors who have never been in an NC2A match.
Yeah.
Got to play in a really epic battle here tonight. Courageous performance by Hawaii and by Baylor. And it was just too bad, as you said earlier, that one team had to lose.
So let's go a little more macro here. Hawaii goes 18-9 for the season. A second consecutive first round loss, albeit dramatic. How do you summarize 2018 for the Rainbow Wahine?
I'd say that Robin Amos Santos and her staff pushed all the buttons they could push, utilized so many players in so many positions, and they all played, I think, for the most part, to their potential or above their potential in some cases. I think next year is going to be a little tricky. They lose, three key people, and Yosia might have to set next year instead of pull double duty, unless they get a setter in the offseason. But we'll see. It sort of certainly become bigger because the recruiting class is pretty big size-wise.
Yeah, and they're bringing in some much-needed help on the outside in terms of hitting. They have some middles that will also be adding to the depth there. It'll be interesting to see what they do at the libero position, because, I mean, you're talking about 34 digs from Tita Q. You can't replace that no matter what you do, but this year
maybe
in particular.
With 3 players you could.
Yeah, you could.
11
yeah, if you're allowed to play 3 liberos at once. But she is just one of those irreplaceable talents. So that's another area where it's going to be interesting for Robin Amos Santos and his staff.
Yeah, it's going to be very challenging, to say the least. The offseason will be interesting. Robin Amos Santos has already told them when the first day of practice is. She did so at the banquet. She said, January 7th, by the way, you guys be there. We're going to run no matter what happens. So she's looking forward to the challenge. I'm sure the players coming back will look forward to the challenge. But what a way to go out, 16-14 in the fifth. It doesn't get much more sad than that.
Well, it's the greatest thing about sports, right? Because at the end of the day, even at the end of a bitter disappointment like that five-set loss to Baylor was, you can say, you know what? There's always next year.
Yeah, they gave it their best shot, too.
And there certainly is. Yeah, absolutely no reason for this team to be ashamed of the effort it put forth in making the NCAA tournament and taking a nationally ranked team all the way to the end of a fifth set. That will do it for us. Thanks to the University of Oregon for being such gracious hosts for us. For CMAC, Chris McLaughlin, I'm Kanoa Leahy. We'll see you during the men's volleyball season coming up on the other side of the new year. Until next time, everybody, on behalf of the rest of the Spectrum Sports crew, we wish you aloha from Eugene, Oregon.